Yo, everybody, what's up? Welcome to OTK Elevated Episode 5, and I'm going to be real. We're doing this on my channel today. Last time I did it with Asmin and Emmy, it's kind of a low pussy, not going to lie. Today, we are not here to make friends. We are not here to be nice. We're here to do what needs to be done. We are going to be sending home 5 contestants today. That's not true. We're going to be breaking some hearts today. We're going to be telling people how it is, because at the end of the day, you know, a disingenuous compliment is infinitely more damaging than a truthful, constructive criticism. We are here to break hearts. We are here to tell people what they need to hear. And I could not be happier with what guest stars I have today, because today we have the literal god, one of the greatest gamers on Twitch. We have Emeru. Emeru, welcome to the stream.
Oh, I thought that was for Asmin. Hi, Techie.
Hi, you excited? Hi.
I'm very excited. I'm sad, though. A lot of people that I was rooting for were eliminated, but I'm excited to see the new contestants today.
Yeah, I'm the exact same, to be honest. It's rough, but, I mean, there's a lot of promising young talent here today. I mean, we do still have one contestant. We have one contestant who's been here from the beginning, which is Mayor Words, which today might be his last day, because I'll be real, I don't fucking like the guy.
What the hell, Techie? Okay, so you're actually going hard today. Okay, I see how it is.
Yep, we're going to do what needs to be done. All right. Well, I'm glad that you're here. We have 2/3 of the Steak and Eggs podcast, and we have one more guest to introduce, but thank you for being here, Emmy.
Hell yeah.
Before I introduce the last host for today, guys, I want to give a big shout out to Progressive and Allied for sponsoring this. We love Progressive. We love Allied Esports. And yeah, it's going to be good. Very glad that y'all will be supporting the channel of OTK. And for the next guest, we have the literal god, one of the greatest gamers on Twitch, one of the forefathers of MMOs. We have Asmongold.
Are we rehearsing? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. All right. Yo, what up, boys? Hey, yo, I'm glad to be here. Hey, what's going on, guys? We excited?
Why are you on your phone, Asmin? Are you playing Honkai?
I was checking something important. Somebody tweeted at me and said I was bad.
No, they would say that?
They said that about me. I can't believe it.
What, aren't you the guy who ruined Diablo 4?
Yes, I am, and I'm glad to do it. Yeah, you're welcome, by the way, Diablo 4 players, for that. Yeah, I'll be doing that even more. But I'm excited. So how many, speaking of ruining, how many dreams are we going to ruin today? What do you think?
I think we're going to ruin as many dreams as Blizzard ruined Overwatch 2 players' dreams.
I don't know if we have that many contestants.
Yeah, we really don't.
There's 6 today.
Yeah, there's 6. And I'm going to be real, Asmin. Last time I kind of made you do the dirty work, okay?
Yeah.
Because you were the executioner. Today I'm gonna be doing that for you, man. If I don't, just call me a pussy, okay? I'm here to hurt
people's
feelings.
You will pussy out.
I will.
No, I won't, because here's the reality. The moment I put my shades on, I get
infinite
confidence.
What if Emeru comes in and she just shits on somebody and just completely ruins their life and they remember it 20 years later?
I mean it might have already happened.
Oh,
but
really?
We'll see.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah.
I mean, here's the reality, guys. I mean, a lot of these contestants who have made it past one or two rounds are starting to get a little bit of an ego, okay? Yeah. And we need to shut that shit down real quick before it gets
reality
out of control.
Reality check.
Yep, we will be the reality checkers.
Like, okay, good. Well, what the fuck? What are we even doing today? Like, I don't even know. Like, I got my car fixed today, and so I just got home maybe like 15 minutes ago. So I really have no idea what's going on. I have no clue. So apparently this is not Parasocial. This is Elevated I'm on today.
Yeah, here, why don't I give you the quick rundown, Asmin? So first of all, so OTK decided to make a wonderful game show called Elevated to give a spotlight to young and upcoming bright creators on this wonderful platform that we have, Twitch. You know, it's very hard to get discovered, so we're here giving them a platform. But today, I gave them all a challenge. And the challenge, I think, might be the hardest challenge they've had so far. Because the reality is that, Asmin, you took my idea for your episode. Not even sure if you know that.
Well, I think that gives me a lot of credit, considering that I actually did nothing. Like, I said, well, you guys, I said, you guys could figure out whatever the hell you want me to do. I'm a dancing monkey. And just start clapping and I'll dance along. And
wait, so production took my idea and gave it to you?
Well, yeah, because they knew I'd do it better.
Oh my God, bro. Shut up! Oh, Becky!
So did you watch my stream last night?
Wait, what were you doing? I'm pretty sure I did. What'd you do? Oh, yeah, the light cone!
Winners win.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. I'm not gonna lie, bro. That broke my spirit. And today, letting y'all know that we're gonna have an ego check for not only contestants, we're having it for us as well. Because I told every contestant to make a roast video on each member of OTK. And y'all two are gonna be ripped to shreds today.
And not you. You think you're safe?
No, I'm not. I'm not safe. So we are here to shit on OTK. It is gonna be amazing.
I feel like it's gonna be so easy to make jokes about me and Tectone. Being bald, being stupid, being bad at video games. I wonder what's gonna happen with Emmy. What do you think?
They say all those things about me too. What?
They say
you're
bald.
Oh yeah, people say all those things about me. What the hell are you talking about?
Well, there was that one clip of you on the podcast and like your forehead was like this big.
Yes, Cameron did that and he doesn't understand. He ruined my life.
Well, how would he do that?
Because people think it's real and now they say that every
time
I like show up in a new
chat. If it's not real, how is it on the camera?
Oh
my God. What do you mean think it's real?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't even know what Cameron is. What do you mean?
This is fucked up. This is fucked up.
Show off that big old forehead.
Wow. Oh, no. See, I told you it wasn't edited.
Oh, wow. Okay.
We got six contestants. Is that right?
Yep, six contestants.
And how many of them are new?
I believe two of them.
Thank God.
Yep. And I'm hoping to eliminate 3 to 4 today, and I'm also
Oh my God!
That's the goal, and I want to leave here with a new insecurity. I'm gonna be real.
Okay.
I don't want to see the low hanging fruit. I mean, obviously, address them, get out of the way. You know, bald, lost $500,000 on God's game. I want to walk here being uncomfortable with who I am. Mm-hmm. That's how hard I want them to go.
Oh, we're gonna be very, very hard today. I'm excited.
Yeah. All right, so today we are talking about the old schedule of Elevated. We have my episode happening today. And on episode 6, we have, May 18th, we have Soda Poppin'. That's going to be a great-ass episode if he decides to stop playing World of Warcraft while the show's going on. After that, we have The Variety Gamer by May 24th. That's about a week, so by that time, he should have cleared at least maybe one or two more Dark Souls bosses or quit the game. On the 8th, we have May 25th. S-Fan TV for episode 8. That's going to be a good-ass episode. And then episode 9 and episode 10, May 31st and June 1st, we have two new members of O2K doing the show. That's a lie. We have two episodes happening with people who we don't know yet. It's going to be good. But pretty much here's how the game show works for any new viewers of OTK Elevated. There are 6 contestants, and they must compete against one another in 10 distinct challenges, each of which will test a unique aspect of streaming. In order to advance the next episode, today's contestants will need to receive 3 or more yes votes. 2 or more no votes will result in an elimination. Elevated is a gauntlet-style show where contestants who are eliminated are replaced week to week with an equal number of new players. Using the Elevated extension, chat can cast their vote for or against the contestants, acting as the 4th judge. That's right, chat. You will be a judge for who you want to see, or more so, who you don't want to see.
So is this where I get to talk?
Yeah, go ahead, man.
So, yeah, I mean, I'm excited. I think that, I always like seeing the new people, you know, because, like, I want to have, it's kind of like, watching a new show. It's like, you want to know if you're going to like it or dislike it. It's like first episode, seeing what's going to happen, etc. I'm excited for that.
You know what I'm excited for and to check out for the first time? This progressive video that we're going to watch together.
Oh,
well, right,
we got
now.
A video this time? All right.
Yeah, we do.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait, so never mind. There's going to be a little picture of progressive.
Hell yeah.
Progressive snapshot. Oh, man.
That's right. There,
hey,
you guys.
Yo, Asmund, do me a favor. Do the ad read for me real quick.
All right. Where is it?
Oh, it's like right there below. Same spot.
Where?
Yeah, it's the same spot. There's an ad read for Progressive Snapshot. The voting doc. You know what to do.
You're doing great.
I don't have the document up. Oh, I didn't have that.
Yeah, so okay. The thing about Progressive Snapshot is that Progressive Snapshot.
I see. All right. Hey, yo, I got it. See, because I wasn't prepared because I had no idea what was going on, right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, I get that.
So, all right, now we're calibrated. Okay, Progressive Snapshot. Progressive Snapshot rewards you for good driving. Check out more at progressive.com. Shout out to Progressive for sponsoring the stream, building up Twitch, and helping us find the new wave of talent. So, hearts in the chat for Progressive.
Amazing. Cool. Dude, I love Progressive. So last week on OTK Elevated, we had some pretty serious stuff happen. I mean, a lot of people got a lot. Oh my God, 2,700 followers for Miss Skillshots.
Oh, they
2,100
love her.
For Suncracker, dude. Mr. Pimple only got 1,700, and he tried to set himself on fire. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Bro.
What do you mean only? That's a lot.
Bro, he almost set himself.
That's a lot of people.
For setting yourself on fire, though.
Yeah, I feel like chat needs to get over there and give him some more follows, you know what I'm saying?
He should get at least 2,000 followers for setting himself on fire.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Reasonable.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
But I feel like today we have an amazing stream for everybody involved, for us, the judges, and, you know, we get an ego check for the contestants, and then we get the ego check of, you know, OTK as a whole. I feel like it's going to be a good-ass episode.
So they get to roast each one of us, is that right?
Yeah, I believe the contestants. Actually, I don't want to spoil it for chat. You know, we have. Obviously, there's only six contestants, so only six members of OTK can get roasted.
They each do one. Okay.
They each do one, and they each got assigned someone to shit on, which was my idea.
Oh my God, assigned someone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wait, who was spared then? Four people got
all
spared.
I bet all six of them got assigned me.
I mean, the good news is anybody who got spared is probably because they were a pussy and they couldn't handle the truth of what the contestants were going to say about them. So anybody who doesn't get a roast video, just know that they're probably very insecure.
So you're not getting one?
Maybe. I mean, we'll see, man.
We'll see what happens. Okay.
Yeah,
All right. We'll find out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, my God. All right, I think we're actually ready to get into our first introduction of the new contestants.
Good job, Aaron.
Yeah. So one of our first contestants is Zion Kaid. Had 144 followers going into today's stream and had 7 average viewers. I actually talked to this guy before the episode, and apparently he's a professional ballerina dancer. He streamed in 2021, took a whole year off in 2022 because it was a pretty rough year, and now he's back in 2023. And he's here to give content creating a shot. And, you know, I feel like that's a very relatable story. I mean, you know, sometimes we have rough years, but he has decided that this year is his year and he's going to get into it. You know, he's a.
I like where this guy is coming from. I'll tell you that. It's like, look at that last line. Zion is financially upside down. Zion is broke. Gentlemen, what better reason to start streaming than if you need money? And I like that. You know, it's direct. It's upfront. There's no parasocial. He not your friend, bro. He in it for the money. I like that.
Yeah, we have a video, but even more important than Zion, I'm just going to make a quick announcement. Chat, we just hit 100,000 subscribers on Steak and Eggs. So dude, I'm going to just go ahead and say that shit. Oh, that just happened. That legit just happened. So for all y'all follow Steak and Eggs,
holy shit.
I appreciate the hell out of that, y'all. That's huge.
That was really fast. God damn.
Yeah.
Congratulations, guys. We did it.
Well, now that I took away Zion spotlight, why don't we go ahead and put it back on him and show the old video of Zion. Let's see.
All right, let's watch it.
Bro, I fucking love Little Nightmares, bro.
I am running. Yo! Sorry if I'm loud. Wait!
Bro, I love that game.
Is that Luigi's Mansion?
Nah, it's Little Nightmares. Little Nightmares 2, actually. Bro.
Okay.
That is a good ass game. Now, I'm not gonna lie, off to a bad start with me. I'm not gonna lie, already don't like the guy.
Oh, really? Said, why not?
He said, sorry that I was loud. I mean, come on, man.
What the fuck?
You know, don't apologize for who you are, bro. Just be who you want to be. So already, I'm saying, I already hate this guy.
Okay.
He's gonna say this about a lot of people today.
Okay, dude. Yeah,
so I love how you know what the funny fucking thing is going to be, guys, is whenever at the end of the show, when it comes to the rating, Tectone, like, he plays himself up so much, but then whenever it actually comes time to make the execution, oh, now he's like, oh, well, you know, like, I mean, why don't you go first? Why don't you just tell him? Why don't you break the news? Why don't you let them know? You know, I'm not sure if I'm ready for that yet.
It's not like that, dude.
No, it's harder to go second. We talked about this. Because then, you're the final deciding vote. It's harder to go second. You got the easy job last time.
No, I didn't. I think that going first is the worst. Because, no, there's no way. Because, like, whenever I say what I say, it is so fucking definitive. There's no way.
Okay,
there's no way somebody's going to go.
Just let's never make Asmund go first today. It's only
good. Then I will go first every time.
Sure. Okay. That's okay.
Okay. Cool. Listen, man, I don't have to care. Okay. Today we're on my stream, so I don't have to care. When I'm on MA, I have to pretend that I have emotions. But now that I'm here, I don't have to fake shit anymore. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So next, I believe we have Evan's social media here. Yeah. Well, look at that. 14,000 followers. That's average viewership 14. So I actually talked to this guy. I have a little bit of lore after I read his bio. But this is you probably know Evan Gao is the guy who did a backflip outside of NVIDIA HQ dressed in a maid outfit. So here's a fun fact. This dude used to have 20,000 viewers. 20,000 viewers about a year after he won a Ludwig competition. And how the mighty have fallen. He told me that
Ludwig fell off then, huh? Because, like, the clout's not that good anymore. Is that right?
Yeah, I guess so, man.
Wow. Okay. So we need Evan to take his place.
Yeah, we do. And, you know, it's crazy. This guy had all that luscious, beautiful hair, and he's fucking bald now, guys.
There's no way.
Evan's life is real rough.
If that's the case, I'm going to have to lay down after this show.
Yeah,
I know. Down for a while.
He lost all that shit, man. So, I mean, he's trying to turn his life around again. He's trying to be back on the up and up. And maybe today will be the day he turns his life around, because right now it's not looking so good.
So he did a backflip dressed in a maid outfit? Bro, like, I wore a maid outfit before. That would be hard to do.
I will never do that. I will never wear a maid outfit, ever.
Oh, really? But you do a backflip, though?
Yeah, I'll do a backflip. Okay, I'll do that shit right now.
But, all right. So do we have like a highlight for Evan?
Yeah, we do. We can play it.
My literature review was specifically on how it can be used to help people with PTSD.
Oh, a subathon!
Oh my god,
dude!
Oh
what?
My god, it's so choppy. Sick. Oh no,
Evan,
so cool.
Evan, sick. I'm getting PTSD right now, actually.
Bro. I love that.
That's like
sick.
Super Monkey Ball, man. I used to play that game all the time.
Yeah, that.
Oh, that's one of the best games.
It is the best game.
Good shit.
Oh, I used to love that so much.
But that game is so frustrating.
No.
That was like
Yeah, it is.
That was actually like the original Souls, like one of the most frustrating games of all time that's designed to break people.
So let me go ahead and say this again. Super Monkey Ball was the original Souls-like?
Yep.
That's crazy.
Why is that?
That's crazy. I never heard that before.
I know.
Wow.
What can I say, man? I'm not here to follow the footsteps. If you follow the footsteps, you'll only get to places where people have already been, okay? That's my opinion. That's the hardest game ever made. That is the game that broke people before Demon Souls.
What do you mean, dude? Like, I remember, like, I used to play that every day. Like, I used to hit myself in the head with a controller over that game.
Yeah, but you do that over anything, man.
Yeah.
So going into this, out of curiosity, who do you think is going to do well and who do you think is going to do poorly?
I feel like Evan's probably going to do all right, because like any dude that's willing to go out, take his shirt off, run around the fucking pool with a goddamn ball around him, like that's somebody that doesn't care about anything and he's willing to do what it takes to let people know what's up. So I'm feeling good about Evan in that regard.
I'm going to be real. I don't think Evan's going to do good at all. I think he's going to absolutely fumble. I talked to him before the show. He told me that all he does is play Minesweeper. And that's it. Doesn't watch TV shows. Doesn't play video games. He plays Look at that.
Oh my
That's all he does. I asked him for anything. All he does is play Minesweeper. There's something wrong with this guy. And I don't know if he has it in him. You know, when the calculations are gone, when it's just about, you know, raw, unadulterated, unfiltering, verbal annihilation of OTK members, I don't think he's going to have what's in him. I don't. There's no formula for that.
He's hiding some rage or something, though, if he just does that all day.
Yeah, I feel like this is some American psycho shit.
Yeah, it's really fucked up. And then also, I'm going to be real, and I'm hoping that I'm wrong. I think today's the day Mayor Wirtz is going home. I'm going to be real.
Is it time to ruin the dream?
Look at him. That guy is fucked up because he knows that his life is in shambles right now. He knows that he's going up for a contest that I don't think he can handle. Mayor Wirtz is one of the most positive, most kind people I've ever met. I'm not sure if he has a bad bone in his body. I don't know if he has the bloodlust, the carnage inside of him in order to rip. Especially with the target that he has, it's a hard one. It's a hard one.
Okay.
Because the reality is, I mean, depending on who the contestants got assigned, the difficulty level is much higher, right? It is. Like, I would say if you get extra Emily or if you get Soda, that's gonna be hard.
It's hard for Soda.
Why do you say that? I feel like Soda's one of the hardest.
Did you ever hear about the story about the door?
No.
This is a sponsored stream.
Oh, it's a sponsor? Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I've never heard of that at all. Okay.
Me either. I never have.
Okay. Well, you know, maybe we don't talk about who's doing good, who's doing bad. Let's just go ahead and introduce the rest of the contestants for anybody who doesn't know. We have our first contestant here. Mayor Wirtz.
Mayor Wirtz.
Hello. How is everyone doing?
I'm doing great.
Doing fantastic. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I got word that Tech was saying not nice things about me. Tech, would you confirm that? I heard something along the lines of, I hate this guy. Is that true?
Yeah. I mean, the reality is, Mayor Wirtz, that you have slid by for the past four episodes, and you've been you got lucky, kid. You got lucky.
Okay. Slid. Slid is the right word we're going to use. Gotcha. Okay, so make sure we're very clear.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I don't know if you have, I don't know if you have it in you to go ahead and roast. Okay. I'm not sure who you got, but roasting, I'm not sure if it's in your wheelhouse, man. But, I'll pull back if you think that I'm making a bad call. But maybe
No. You're the judge here. You're the judge here. I just, I got word that you're saying that you hate me. And, I wanted to confirm it and hear it from the source entirely.
Yeah, I got you, big guy.
Yeah, something about that. He's trying to say he wants to fail you, ruin your dreams, end your chances on the show, and that he hates you. I mean, but that's about it, though.
That's like,
said he was going to go in.
Okay, he's going to go in today. That's fair. I think that's fair. He is, is on his channel. He can do what he pleases. I just wanted to hear it.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'm glad I was able to deliver that to you. And Mayor Wirtz, I hope you prove me wrong, buddy.
Perfect.
Do you think you will? Do you think you're going to kill it?
I think I'm going to do pretty well, and I think I'm going to surprise you the most.
Okay. I'm ready. I like the look in your eye, man. You look ready to annihilate.
I'm ready.
Okay. All right. Well, Mayor Wirtz, good luck.
Thank you.
Yep. And now for a quick little quote from Progressive. You can actually go to Progressive for an auto insurance quote on auto, home, and more. Check out progressive.com for more info. And thank you again, Progressive, for sponsoring this episode of OTK Elevated.
Shout out to Progressive.
Yep. Thanks, and next we have a man who quite literally set himself on fire in order to get to the next round. And someone who I think is looking quite promising for today's episode, we have Mr. Fimple.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. I think you're looking pretty promising today, too. You look great.
Hey, thanks, man. I appreciate that. Out of curiosity, who do you hate the most on OTK if you were just a name drop?
That is a tough one. There's a lot of good options. I'd probably say NMP.
Yeah, there is.
A lot of good options, but I'll go NMP. I feel like,
Yeah, okay. True.
Yeah. Definitely NMP. Yeah, I feel like
we hate
it's the right answer.
The guy's got such a big ego. Thinks he's better than everybody. It's a lot, man. Like, I guarantee you, he'd be 80 years old talking about being a gladiator.
And he always is like, oh, I grew this streamer. He hasn't helped me at all. I haven't grown at all from an MP. What has he done for me?
But you would like him more if he did help you grow as a streamer.
Of course. Yeah, I mean, I can switch up. I'm not
like, hey, yo, fucking MP. Guy's yeah, a joke.
But if he helps me out, like, I'll switch up my tune.
Out of curiosity, are you bringing out the gasoline today?
Maybe. I don't think production likes the gasoline too much, but it might come out at some point. I got to keep it a surprise.
Yeah, I don't think production or Emmy's webcam enjoys gasoline like at all. But do you feel?
Didn't want to be in the same session.
She didn't want to be in the club. Do you think you killed it today, or do you think you fumbled?
I think I did pretty cool. I tried to make something as creative as I could. You know, I feel like getting a video prompt, you can make it super creative. So I wanted to take that into liberty and just make something that's super fun for chat and for you.
Cool. So for the person who you got assigned, because I know everybody got assigned an OTK member, how do you feel about him? Do you like him or do you not like him?
I mean, I don't want to leak, but I think I already said my answer.
Okay. You know? All right. And I'm excited, dude.
I don't like him. I do not like him.
All right. Well, Mr. Fumble, I want to wish you the best of luck. And yeah, glad to have you here, buddy.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here.
Cool. See you later. All right. Dude, there's something about that Fimple guy that I just like a lot.
Why? Is it because he's going to roast somebody you don't like?
I don't know. Shit, maybe. But there's just something about him, and he has something about him that I enjoy. I think it's the fact that I know that his life is probably crumbling when he would do something like setting himself on fire for a contest on stream. I really like that.
That is, if you're willing to do that, that's some fucking like Squid Game shit, right? And so you gotta be down bad.
Yeah. I mean, shit, I feel like maybe I need to do that.
Really? You wanna set yourself on fire?
Yeah, you should try it.
Well, you know, actually, for my first MySpace photo of all time, I set my arm on fire. That way I could do the Chidori from Naruto.
Oh, wow. I like that.
It was sick. Yeah, I covered it in like this. So cool. I covered it in like this. Wait, do you think I'm lying?
She's...
No, I'm just saying it's really cool. Yeah. It's so
she's
cool.
Depressed.
Oh, okay. Sick.
It's so cool, dude.
Yeah, I mean, it's awesome, right? I mean, it's super cool. Anyways, we need to introduce our next contestant. That is Miss Skillshots, the resident weeb.
Weed.
Hi, Miss Skillshots.
Hi.
Hello.
Wait, you're wearing the same shirt, bro? Do you have other clothes?
I have just cosplays or this shirt.
Why are you wearing that two episodes in a row?
Three episodes in a row.
Yeah, why are you doing that? Why are you doing that?
Because it's a uniform.
Is it?
Yeah.
What do you mean by it's a uniform? What do you mean by that?
Yeah, because it's one less thing to worry about when you stream. I just got to wear this. And
I completely agree with you.
Oh,
thank you. Yeah.
Yep. I think this is a great idea.
I'm a streamer. I don't think.
So do you think streamers are stupid on average?
They say people think they're smarter than average when actually they're not.
Uh-huh.
So a lot of streamers do think they're smart. So I think that answers its own question.
So wait, hold up. So if a streamer thinks they're stupid, it makes them smart. And if a streamer thinks they're smart, it makes them stupid.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, I like that. That makes sense. Sure. I get it.
So here's the thing. When Asmund asked you, do you think streamers are stupid? I sense some uncomfortability. Okay. I'm going to be real. I'm not sure if you have the killer instinct that today's episode is going to require. Do you think you did good on today's challenge? Or was it very difficult?
Did well, Tectone. Did well.
Oh, did well.
I think you will see and you will find out once you see it. You will. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Because I'm going to be real, and I'm just saying, okay? You're a weeb. We're a dying breed, okay? But I'm gonna say what I need to say, and if I have to vote off a weeb, I will, but just know that I'm not going to enjoy it, but I will do what I need to do.
Why do you say she's a weeb?
Look at her shirt, bro. She's wearing a Heart Pirate One Piece shirt, dog.
So, like, I mean, like, a lot of people like that show, right? Or like that.
Yeah, if you like anime, you're a weeb.
No.
Is it that simple? So even if you like one anime, you're automatically a weeb?
Yep.
You're a weeb, Asmund.
Yeah, you're a weeb. You're literally a weeb.
Hey, yo, I was in the anime club in high school. So I'm not.
So no, I don't think not. That's. No, you weren't. You were literally.
No, you were
dude,
not.
I literally saw.
Hey, yo, I'm gonna keep it real. All right, listen. Y'all fucking think I'm lying about that shit. Emmy, listen. The reason why is because I thought that the girls in anime would be like the ones that would be at the club. That wasn't the fucking case. So you know what happened? I stopped going.
Okay, that's fair.
See, you immediately believe it whenever I explain it that way.
Yeah, well, when you put it like that, it makes perfect sense.
It sure does.
Oh, fuck.
Can you stop breaking Emmy's webcam, Ms. GoFast, yeah. Please? Like, chill the hell out.
Why is a tripod
no,
wearing a hat?
No, there can only be one girl on the screen.
Oh, it's Highlander? I like
it. Okay. Well, Ms. GoFast, I'm worried about you, but I hope you prove me wrong, and I hope you fucking bring it today, man.
Thank you.
Of course. Good luck. All right,
damn.
Next up.
So, like, what's going on with that camera? Is it just overheating?
I don't know. I might have to crawl around under the desk to try to figure this out when I get the chance. But hopefully for now, it's safe.
You have to use the webcam while you do it. That way, it'd just be just like Dark Souls, right?
Okay, well, I don't want to show how bad under my desk is right now.
So you could.
No, don't worry about it. I'll fix it. It's fine. Production is saying to show it. You know what? Okay. Maybe I will. But I have to see if I can get it working.
Wait, you're going full webcam, Mike? Sure. Well, Emmy gets ready. Let's go and introduce the next contestant. Let's introduce Mr. Suncracker. Yeah.
Hey, what up, bro? How you doing?
Hey, what's up, Mild?
You excited for today?
A little bit. I'm a little nervous because I feel like you've already shown your bios, Tectone.
Wait, what are you talking about?
I'm the only contestant not in your title today.
Oh, yeah, it's because I don't like you.
Yeah, I've already gotten that. So, dude, I'm the only one who you're already, like, fucking over.
Well, I mean, what can I say, man? You're wearing a One-Punch Man shirt, and that shit's overrated, so I don't know what you want me to do, man.
Listen, man, if only they had made a season 2, okay?
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
It really wasn't that great now, was it? It was pretty rough.
It was pretty rough. No, I got this for like $2 on Wish.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So I'm okay with it. I feel like the value's paid off.
Do you think you killed it today?
I think I'm going to kill it today. I'd also like to say, Asmin, it's nice of them to let you host a third episode.
I absolutely agree. I mean, like, occasionally I've let Tectone or Emeru take over, and that's just been a complete disaster. So, I'm really glad to be here. And honestly, guys, I think we're going to just completely, guys, we're going to have a great episode today.
Dude, you've got the same shirt as last episode, too, so I feel like it's my good luck charm.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, everybody loved you last week, and I could probably see why Tectone wasn't able to put you in the title based on your name. Makes sense.
Obviously.
But that's the way it goes. And listen, like, I'm excited to have you here. I definitely am. Who's that fat guy? Who is that?
Who?
Wait, the guy. Yeah, who's in the pictures? And your little, who's the big fat guy?
Oh, that's me 4 months ago, so...
Congrats.
I was watching Camp Canute, and I decided to lose some weight. And
are you serious?
Unlike Dick Tone, I actually did.
Wait, dude, I lost 70 pounds.
70 pounds. Bro, you lost 70 viewers, okay? Nobody.
More than that.
What are you on about, bro? Just make it. Oh, I hate this guy, bro. No, it's okay. Dude. Okay. Yo, talk your best, man.
Lastly, I gotta say, I have been sick since last episode, but don't worry, chat. I still feel better than Tectone looks, so we're gonna kill it today.
Okay.
We're gonna have a good time.
Okay, buddy. All right.
He's ready for today.
I am going to enjoy watching you suffer at the end of this episode.
Anybody else notice that Tectone's finally quiet today?
Yeah, he
I
is,
cannot
because
wait.
Now he actually, he can't just be, he has to host the show. So now he can't just rely on coming in every once in a while with a funny comment. Now he actually has to do something.
Bro, Asma, what are you on about? What is every day, man? Every day I'm my back against the wall for no reason. Hey, here's the reality, buddy. Okay, Sonny, I'm not going to call you by your full name, okay? Because obviously I don't want to get banned. Just gonna be real.
That's fine.
Don't like you. Whether you do good or not, I'm saying no regardless. So I hope you enjoy
that
thing, man.
Hey, everyone you said yes to has gotten kicked off the show. I don't want your vote.
said okay!
That's actually true. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, Ulfi, Navius, it's over.
Yeah, that's true. Well, Sonny, hey, man. Wish you the best of luck, buddy.
Thanks, guys.
Cool. I like that guy.
I do, too. I think he's great. That's crazy who lost that much weight on Camp Canute. Oh, my God. I never knew it had that effect on people. That is so cool, man. Holy shit.
Dude. Well, like,
and
if
you
ever
lost
went
70
to, like, a
pounds?
Yeah. I was 330. I dropped to 260. And then right now I'm down to 241. So I've lost about 90 pounds in total since Camp Canute, which I'm really happy about.
I'm pretty sure if I lost 90 pounds, I wouldn't exist anymore.
Yeah, 100%. But dude, I'm excited, man. Like that scenario right there, we can see that quick wit just ripping people to shreds. I mean, that's exciting, man. I'm gonna be real. I'm thinking I probably know who his video's on. Really good.
I've got a bit of an idea, you know?
Yeah, got a bit of an idea who might have been researching.
A little bit of evidence, context clues, stuff like that. Yeah.
But what's also, wrong? I will say, are you good at me?
No,
I'm great.
I can tell.
Okay, cool. Yeah,
don't
like
worry,
Asmund, every single time,
I got this.
Every single time we go to a con, like people come up and talk about like how much of an effect Camp Canute like had on their lives.
Really?
Like, it's crazy. Oh yeah, like I've had people like in tears, like thanking like me and like Miz for like doing an event like Camp Canute, like how it changed their life, all that stuff. Like Camp Canute was one of the coolest things ever done on Twitch. Like, I loved that era of Twitch. I hope to God we do Camp Canute again, like 100%.
That's
you should
insane.
Go on it.
You
should
You think I should go on Camp Canute?
Yeah, get jacked. Save your head. Get jacked.
That sounds like a great idea for a person that leaves the house.
Yeah,
it sounds like such a good idea.
It's good.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, if I ever went on it, I would maybe, you know what I would do? I think I would start taking steroids if I went on Camp Canute. That way I could have an advantage over everybody else, you know?
Well, no, I mean, you'd be on the same playing field as Miz.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, true.
Yeah.
Good point.
Well, next up, we have our next contestant, which is Zion. Yo, Zion, how you doing, buddy?
Hi, Zion.
What's up? Can y'all see me?
This is your first episode of OTK Elevated. How you feeling, big guy?
I'm feeling good. I'm pumped. This is a challenge that's up my alley, and I'm
okay. Now, why do you say that? Why do you say this challenge is up your alley?
Because I grew up with my my brothers doing YouTube videos, and I'm a filmmaker.
Say no more.
So this is good. I'm pumped.
So you used to do ballet.
Yeah. Yeah, I used to do ballet. When I was 11, I did like tap and hip hop. But then when I was 15, I got really serious, moved to Seattle, did ballet, and got a job in Minnesota. And then it all went to shit because of COVID. So then moved back to Georgia with my parents and started streaming.
Oh, man, that is so badass.
Yeah, thank you. There's not a lot of ballet, like, dancing content on Twitch.
Right. Do you want to do some right now?
Do some right now?
Yeah, go ahead.
I don't know if my camera will be able to see it.
Let's see. Do something crazy. Okay. I don't even know what ballet is, to be honest. Wait, do some crazy shit.
It's like dancing.
Okay, well, let's see it.
You can't really see me, though.
Yeah, let's okay. Yeah,
it's a bit
do
hard
a backflip.
To do.
The backflip?
Yeah, can you do a backflip?
I don't think that's a ballet move.
So, okay, well, I think Emeru's messing me up now. Yeah, Emeru's messing me up now.
Oh, no,
right,
it's spreading.
Now?
It's spreading.
It's spreading.
I'm so
sick
sorry.
Of disease. Okay, so I can't really do ballet, but
there's no way you could do it like that. But
I am not about to break my ankles for you guys.
I get it, bro. I get it. That is incredible. So you did that until COVID, and then you decided to get into streaming.
Damn. Oh, you saw that? You like that?
Okay. Oh, shit, man.
Okay.
Damn.
The ankles messed me up, but yeah.
Uh-huh.
You like that? I know you like that, Tectone.
That was good, man.
Sweet.
Okay, well, I'm glad you are a self-proclaimed jackass, as you said when you first came in here. And
Dude, hey, all streamers are. You play Gacha, I dance, that's it.
Yep, that's just scumbag human beings. Well, Zion, I want to wish you the best of luck, and glad you're here, buddy.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Glad to be here.
Sweet. I'll be real. I hate that guy.
Yeah, true. True. So true, man. I hate him too. Emmy, yeah. Do you hate him?
Yeah, I hated him as well.
Okay, good. Yeah, that's great. Cool.
That we're all in agreement. I mean, who the fuck does he think he is coming in here doing those dumbass dance moves? Regardless, last contestant that we need to introduce for today, we have Evan Gao.
A paralyzed person would be great.
Yo, big guy, we're doing a stream here, man. Why are you playing Minesweeper?
Oh, wait, I'm just trying to grind for a world record in the meantime. It's just getting a little boring.
Whoa, this is some American Psycho shit. How are you still playing Minesweeper? Didn't that game come out in, like, 1995?
Yeah, I think it came out before I was born, actually.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, what got you into that?
It was the first... It's a really long story. The first person I saw on stream, I thought he was a bodybuilder. He was lifting, like, he was benching more than my entire weight. And then he sat down at his desk. Okay. Well, it was like 170. But he sat down at his desk. Open up the screen, and it was just Minesweeper. And he finished an expert board in, like, 60 seconds. And I was like, what the fuck? And I wanted to be like him. And I did it out of spite.
So just so you could be on his level?
Yeah. And I've
and so
surpassed
can,
him
can
at
you
this
do?
Point.
Oh, really? So you're definitely, like, way better than he is?
Yeah. I have a world record, actually.
Are you kidding me? So you have a world record in Minesweeper?
It's a really weird category. It's 80 by 2, 12 mines. It's very hard.
Do it. Do what you did. Do it. Do the thing.
Yeah, show us.
Yeah, play Minesweeper. Let's see it.
I'll just do it. I'll just do an intermediate board because I think that's easy.
Yo, okay. It's going to be funny as fuck if you hit a bomb.
Yeah, I've
it's
never
gonna be
beaten,
fucking funny.
I've never beaten Minesweeper ever.
Ever?
No.
It's actually you don't need brain cells for this. It's actually just pattern recognition.
It's just I can't do that.
Screaming. Like you hear a word and you do word association in your head and then it's like it's over. Oh my god, my mouse DPI is actually so bad right now.
It's the DPI
matters for this.
Yeah, no, the DPI.
It's definitely the DPI. I'm definitely not rusty.
Wait, hold up. Yeah, oh my god. Wait, what, bro? What? This is
yeah. So. I'm just doing, sorry it's a little bit slow, like usually I'm way faster. I've got a little bit of nerves right now, you know, I'm on OTK related and all that.
What are you nervous about, man?
Just being too good for the competition, I guess.
That makes sense.
That was 43 seconds, it's kind of a bad time, but.
Wait, so 43 seconds is a bad time?
Yeah, bro. there are people who can do this in like less than 10.
Wow.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Minesweeper community is crazy.
Oh, so you like suck?
No. I'm really good. I'm just again, it's the mouse DPI. It's the DPI.
It's about yeah. It's about that's why I miss shots in Valorant too. Actually, it's
exactly.
Funny that you bring that up. Yeah, that's always what it's like some mouse thing or something with like oh I don't know like the computer, the monitor, like sometimes there's like you know drivers that come out for NVIDIA that cause me to you know miss shots occasionally. So I get
I'm
that.
With you. Every step of the way. I know the feeling.
So let me go back. Let me ask you a little bit of something. Let me ask you, how the fuck did you get in a pool with that little thing on you? With that ball?
The ball?
Yeah.
So my friend, it's actually his ball. He has two of them, and I just climbed into one of his balls.
His ball? Okay.
Yeah. And he has like a giant leaf blower. It zips up and down. And so you just get blown like into the ball, and then it blows up, and then you zip it up.
Okay. Yeah. And so there's like air inside of the ball.
Yes, it runs out very quickly. I nearly suffocated. Five minutes, I was out of oxygen. I was like, oh wait, it's a little too hot. I need to get out of here.
Oh my god, that's insane.
And you can't unzip from the inside. So
wait, so somebody had to come out and save you?
Yeah.
That's a good stream, what the fuck? That's crazy. Oh my
that's
god.
That's awful.
Okay.
Wait, so here's what I don't understand. Okay, so you told me that you used to have 20,000 viewers, and then I saw a photo of you, and you had a whole head of hair. So, like, what happened?
Yeah, man.
Okay, the 20,000 viewers was just because Ludwig raided me once. That's not, like, my average view count.
Oh, okay, I get that. Yeah,
and
but what
for
about
the hair? It's baldness solidarity, you know? I wanted to really fit into the show.
Okay, you want to be like Asmund? I get that. That's cool, man.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Thanks a lot, man. It looks great. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Well, Evan, I wish you the best of luck in today's... Well, actually, I don't wish you the best. Like, I don't care. If you lose, it doesn't matter to me. But I'm, yeah, you're here, so that's cool.
Thank you, thank you.
Bro,
how am I supposed to respond to that?
Yeah, yeah, you can't. No. Don't worry about it, all right? He's been talking himself up like this for the entire show. Like, there's nothing for you to even say. Just smile and nod, and that way he can feel better about bitching out at the end.
I will say I'm really glad I pulled Sile really early on in
the
holiday.
Oh my god!
It was pretty epic.
So how early was it?
It was like 30 pulls.
Wow! So it didn't take you like a whole week or something like that to get it?
No, and I also got the light cone in like 20. It was actually nuts luck. Yeah, yeah.
Wow, that is really good. And so that's what happened. That's what happened for me too, and also Emmy. That's what happened to you also, right?
No, it's not.
Wait, I thought it was.
I got her on a pity.
Well, you know, listen, Evan. You know, I got a phrase for that. You know what it's called?
Yeah.
Winners win.
Amen, brother.
It's just that simple. Yep. There you go. You think you're gonna do well today? Feeling good about it?
I think so. I've made a classic Evan Gal video, and I'm excited for you to see it.
Oh wow. Okay. All right. Okay. I'm excited to see it too.
Good luck, man. Good luck, I'm glad you're here.
All right. Thank you.
Yep. Why is everybody lucky but me, bro?
Why am I so bad at video games? See what's happening with my camera? This is like crazy bad luck. Should I switch to the webcam?
You can do what you want.
Yeah, you can swap.
I don't know what it is.
This is rough, man.
Oh boy.
Wow, is this 2015 again?
I think so.
Yeah, that's crazy.
At least it works, I guess.
Wait, did you swap cameras?
Yeah.
It looks the exact same. Wait, is there actually a difference?
No, it doesn't. No, you think it looks the exact same?
I think it looks the exact same.
You need to switch out your glasses.
Okay, wait, hold up. Let me get the other one.
You gotta switch out your glasses. Like, that's a big difference.
Oh, okay. I can't tell, to be honest.
Somebody in chat said Emmy looked like a corpse.
Chat's not supposed to be part of the competition today.
Yes, they are. Chat, remember, you are a part of this contest. You need to make sure to rip me, Emmy, and Asmin apart today. There will be no bans on stream, so feel free to say whatever you want to say. So we have a fun stream, fun chat. All right, now we introduced everybody, but now we need to get them all together for one celebratory game show and, really welcome all of them in all at once. Contestants! Yo. Hi.
What's up?
Yo.
You excited?
I'm pumped.
Cool.
Whoa, we both did it.
From 1 to 10, how uncomfortable are y'all with today's episode?
I don't know.
I would say probably like a 9.
Sick. Wait, 9 for like that
you told me before. You told me before the stream you want to make us uncomfortable. And then Asmin also liked it when I watched him in the shower last week. You guys are really just wanting us to be as uncomfortable as possible.
What's wrong with watching some dude in the shower? It is what it is.
You said you liked how uncomfortable it made me. That's the only reason you gave me a yes.
Yeah, but I like that because I didn't think that you should have been uncomfortable. Like, there's nothing more manly for one dude to watch another dude in the shower. What's wrong with that?
You're just looking out for a friend. You're looking out for a friend.
Yeah, yeah. You're trying to make sure that he's getting everything done, taking care of himself. Right. What's wrong with that?
No, you got a point. I'm going to step down. That's pretty based. No, I apologize.
You went to Asmin's house?
Well, not on the record, no. But,
his stream. His stream. Not in real life.
on his stream. You think I'm watching Asmin take a shower off stream?
Okay, no. I just wanted to make sure. Okay. Yeah, no, well, here's something really exciting. Guys, we have a giveaway today. I know. On my stream. Insane. We have a StarForge PC giveaway, and here's the crazy thing that a lot of people don't know. This is not the same giveaway as the last one. This is a new one, right? So, like, in total, I believe up to 5 PCs are being given away during Elevated. So, if you didn't enter last week, it's fine. This is a completely new one. So, go ahead and enter the StarForge Voyager Creator Elite giveaway. It does have a GeForce RTX 4090 in it and a Intel Core i9-13900K. And that's a beautiful PC, man. That's a beautiful PC.
I'll let y'all know I have that PC, and it can run Honkai Star Rail with no problem. And I bet it can run Minesweeper, too.
Hog! Yeah, you definitely need the latest graphics card to run Minesweeper. It's very intensive.
Yeah, because you don't want it to get blown up.
Exactly! You get it. Mm-hmm. You got me.
Yeah. Well, that's the prize for everybody in chat, but I do want to remind everybody who's competing here today that you all are competing for, and I am not kidding you, you are competing for $50,000 and the hearts of the people all over the world. That's a lot of money. That is a lot of money. So, okay. I mean, all right.
So
I don't
what
know
are y'all
going to
do with the
that.
Money? Like, if y'all got the money, like, let's go down the line. I want to find out what each one of you guys would do with $50,000. Mayor Wirtz, what would you do with 50 grand?
I would install some drywall in this basement. Yeah. We had to take that down after my basement got flooded. And then, you know, maybe a hot tub. I think a hot tub would be good for my feet.
Oh, for I thought for your stream. But okay, that makes sense.
Well, I mean, it can be both. You know, it can be dual for my stream and for my feet. You know,
that way you can write it off your taxes.
Boom. I'll talk to my accountant about it.
I like that. Smart. All right, what about you, Mr. Fimple? What would you spend 50 grand on right now?
I'd probably get a zoom lens so when I watch you shower, I can at least get like a good shot, you know?
Oh, okay. That's good.
Like 300 millimeter, maybe like 500 millimeters.
Oh, that's delicious. Oh, I love that. Thank you, man.
Yeah,
I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Hey, it's the manliest thing I could do. I got you.
I can't think of anything more manly. Miss Skillshots, what would you do with 50 grand?
Maybe I would donate it to Tectone to get a hair transplant.
Oh, wow. So sweet.
So are you starting the roast now? Does the roast start now? Or Tectone? Do you want to start the timer?
No, yeah, that's great. I would love that. I'm rooting for you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah,
it's because you're gonna give me the my pools, and then I'll just help you too. Pat each other on the back.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I appreciate that. I'll say it right now, my hairline is better than Asmund's. Okay, I'll just say it.
Okay,
if I were to grow my hair out, it would look better. That's the truth.
Okay, sure.
Dude,
is that what you tell yourself? That's fine.
Look,
go ahead.
It's all there, bro. I could grow hair. I just choose not to. It's the truth.
That's crazy. Yeah, I don't know about that. I remember, like, because you did the same thing a lot of balding dudes do. How do I know that? Well, I know that. Is that you started with hair, then you started with a beanie, and then finally you said, I'm going to rip off the Band-Aid, and now you're where you're at.
I wore a beanie because I lived in Canada, and it was cold.
That's the reason.
Yup, because I lived in Canada. It was cold in my apartment. That's all it was. That makes sense.
Songcracker, what would you do with 50 grand?
I had a good answer, but then I heard what Miss Skillshots was doing. I would actually like to pay Tectone to undo that process and go bald, because as bad as he looks now, he looks way worse when he had hair. He looked like Shane Dawson banked Jesse Pinkman, and they left the baby to bloat in the ocean too long.
Oh my god.
Oh my
Tectone
god.
Should not have hair.
What
is going on, man? Holy dude.
Yeah, because it's like he had that scene kid swirl with the hair, right? You know what I mean?
Even like 2004 MySpace, it wasn't a look.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god. Oh
wait. Hey, yo, can we go that way? Oh man.
What is going on? Wow, man.
It looks like your favorite band, Bring Me the Horizon.
Oh my god, dog. Dude, only one of y'all got to sign me, bro. What is happening, dog?
Yikes.
Wow.
Jeez.
You know what's so funny about this? Is my hair used to look exactly like that. I'm talking shit to you, but I looked exactly the same.
Mine looks like that right now.
Yeah, true. All right, let's see. Zion, what would you
Zion,
do with 50 grand? Yeah.
50 grand.
If I went to 50K?
Yeah.
All right, so... Honestly, I had a plan, but after this video, even if I win the 50K, I'm still upside down. So I would pay it all. It was a full-length production. It was a lot. It was crafty. It was cameras. It was makeup artists, hair. It's a lot.
Makes sense. All right. Yeah. I like that. Okay. All right. Good.
All right.
Okay. Let's see. Who else do we have left?
Yo,
oh,
Evan,
shit.
What would you do with $50,000 besides eat like Asmongold for 25,000 days?
Do you want the answer for the video or like my honest answer? Because I can do both.
I want both. Give me both.
All right. Well, like, obviously, I donate all of it to charity. gotta help. Yeah, you know, Child's Play is a good one. Cancer Association. Like, gotta donate to charity. But real, probably go to Vegas. Like straight to Vegas.
True.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Break it out
man.
At the 2-5 tables. Like, oh my god, it's so easy.
Just straight getting it twisted.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Okay, I like that. All right, good. Well, there we go. That's very insightful.
That's sick. All right, well, next up, we should do what we need to do, which is thank Progressive one more time and check out the Claim to Greatness by Progressive. Which, that's some, yo, Asmin, you know what that is. What's the Claim to Greatness? Oh, that's the name of the segment, the Claim to Greatness.
So that's the name of the segment. Let's go ahead. Let's figure it out. So, listen. Yeah. Progressive has been sponsoring the show. Thank you very much to Progressive. And I'm not really sure, like, what else, like, what are you just threw this to me. What the hell you want me to say?
Okay, well, Michelle, what do you want me to say, man? It's a Claim to Greatness Progressive. What else needs to be said, to be honest? I love Progressive. It's my favorite. What do you think about Progressive, Emmy?
I think Progressive is great. Also, I think the segment is when we go in and start watching the videos.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, I agree. That's exactly what it is. You know what we should do before we watch that? We should probably check out the rules and, you know, see what today's challenge is. All right, today's challenge is YouTube. Part of being a streamer is being able to grow on other platforms. I don't want to read this. Yo, Emmy, you read it.
Today's challenge is YouTube. Part of being a streamer is being able to grow on other platforms. And as such, the contestants have been given 1 week to write, film, and edit a YouTube video roasting a member of OTK. So they each got assigned one. They're all doing a different person. Just like Tectone always says, you can't be a big YouTuber without being a bit of a dick. They must also present an appropriate title and thumbnail. They will be judged on the following attributes: creativity, comedy, and editing.
Hey, that's a really good challenge. Whoever thought of that is a genius. I'll just say it. That's got to be one of the best challenges ever put on OTK Elevated ever. What do we think? Emmy, Asmin, how good is that idea?
It's a creative one. Nice job, person who came up with it.
Whoever came up with that, absolute genius. Because the title and the thumbnail is everything. I want to see clickbait. I want to see drama. I want to see red circles pointing at it. I want to see Mr. Beast in the thumbnail with $10,000. I want to see exposing drama. You won't believe all that stuff. So I hope y'all did your research, because the title and thumbnail, it's very important. I'll be real. A title and thumbnail is more important than the content of the video. It's the truth.
Okay. That's true. And I've seen your video, Tectone, so.
They're good, right?
Down. Yeah, you've got that down.
I know. And you know what's very exciting? We get to check out the titles and thumbnails, and chat will be voting which video they want to see first. Here we go. Oh my god! This is so good! Okay. Miss Killshots with the exposure. These are all very, very good thumbnails. Oh my god. Miss Killshots with the Emmy. Mr. Pimple has NMP. Zion has soda. Sonny has me. The mayor wins. He's bald. Oh, and Evan Gao with the extra Emily. Emily Zhang, student, Nebraska Chinese Center. What is this? These are some damn good thumbnails, guys. These are sick. Well, chat, feel free to go ahead and vote on which one y'all want to see first, but I would say, well, but yeah, we saw the thumbnails. What are the titles? What do people really think of Emeru? I don't think that's a necessarily a good title, in my opinion. I think You Won't Believe What Emmy Did would have been better. A night with Nick Pollum. That's okay. What do you think about that title, Emmy?
I mean, I think it's a good title, but I would not click on that video. I would think it was something else. I would click on it, but I would not think it was what it actually is.
Yeah, that might not belong on YouTube. maybe that's for a different platform.
It's fitting, though.
Yeah, that is fitting of my Apex Predator NMP. Very good, dude. All right, next one we have, this streamer gets roasted until he cries. Yes. De-escalated feet soda popping. What do you think, Emmy?
That sounds like a title for a VOD channel.
Yeah, it does. I'm not really sure if I'm getting the whole drama vibes, the roast vibes. from this. I do like the feet soda pop and get that quick little plug to his channel. Mm. But for being like, you know, a hungry up and coming streamer, you need more ruthless, not care about his channel and mainly focus on yours. But I would probably just use soda pop and more prevalent closer to the beginning of the title. That way it doesn't get cut off when you get that ping fort on your
I'm going to be real. I kind of like this one because it's got the red arrow. The red arrow is the good part. The title, Emmy is right. The title sucks, but everything else is good.
Yeah, I think soda should have been bigger on the thumbnail, to be honest.
Yeah,
but wait, Emmy, what did you just do, bro?
It's boom boom.
Why you put that in your nose?
Because it's a nasal stick.
What?
Oh my
god! It clears your sinuses. You don't know about boom boom?
What, no, okay, well, that's a bomb in Mario.
No,
it is.
Boom boom nasal stick.
What Speaking of hell? Bombs, no. I have one to drop right now. The poll results are in, guys. We know what we're gonna watch first, and we're gonna watch Miss Kill Shots first.
That's the one about me, right?
I'm gonna be real.
The one about you.
Oh boy.
I love it. I love that one.
Yeah. All right. So why don't we? Okay, we're going to move everybody out, and Miss Skillshots will be watching your video alongside you, okay?
Okay.
You're first. You nervous?
No.
Good. Don't be. This is going to be fun.
But Emeru should be.
I'm going to be real. Like, I love the title of this video. I think it is so good. Like, this is straight up one of those, like, drama YouTuber titles. Crazy stalker shit. Absolutely. Nutball stuff.
I think the thumbnail's good. I don't think the title's good. I feel like there could be more clickbait for there.
Is supposed to be big, and everything else is supposed to be
it should be
lowercase.
The truth about the drama title would be like that. It's not what people think. It's the truth. It's real. It's 100% real. You have to title it like that.
All right. Well, let's see. Let's go and watch that video and let's see how it goes, because I'll be real. I think a title and thumbnail is more important than the content of the video, but let's see how long you can keep the viewer retention up. Generally, you want to shoot for 44% viewer retention for, I guess, minimum benefit, or like, I guess the minimum standpoint for benefit. So let's see how long you keep it interested. 5 minutes of roasting Emmy. I'm ready.
5 minutes? Okay.
Emmy, you're in this video? Wait, what the What?
It was backwards.
This music is crazy.
Oh.
Okay.
How is my face the top result?
A red filter.
I like that.
Hey!
Okay, I'm liking the drama.
Hey, how's it going?
Nia Rain, hello and welcome.
Oh my god.
Hello,
are these all the eliminated contestants?
Is everyone I said no to?
Hi.
Oh my god.
Hello, Neptune.
Yeah.
As you know,
now
I
we
have
get to know the
summoned
truth.
You here today because I wanted to discuss the unfortunate, the sad, the terrible event. You were recently on Elevated episode 2 and you were voted off all because of Emeru. She did this.
Right? Uh-huh.
So please explain, how do you feel about this? This is your chance to say, you know, something that you truly feel inside about her, you know? It's time to get it out.
Well, I mean, technically it wasn't Emeru that voted me off, though. I mean, she voted yes, actually.
Well, she probably told other people to vote you off.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she likes hamsters more than I do. Maybe that's a little cringe. Like, that's kind of
I don't know.
Yeah. Everybody knows in OTK, Emeru is the ringleader. So however she was going to vote, everybody else is going to vote.
Maybe something more kind of like, you know, take a jab at her. Like something you think you're like, oh, that's kind of weird that you do that every day. Or like something about her. Okay.
The thing is, she's not really my target demographic anyway. I mean, she does a lot of the cutesy cosplay stuff. And
but what let's about put this into another universe. Imagine Emeru actually said no to you on that vote.
Oh my gosh, she's starting drama.
You know, anime and that sort of stuff. And that's not really my vibe, you know?
Yeah.
I don't really know what you're looking for here, but...
Yeah, like, you know, like those pink rubies in the background. Like, what's that all about? Feel free, you know. I'm totally not recording right now. Just feel free to get out all your emotions, you know.
Excuse you?
Yeah, like, congratulations on being a great content creator,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, being a CEO. Wow.
My best friend would never do that to me.
Do you want me to get, like, mad and, like, swear a lot?
So,
Yeah.
Oh, and there's so many talented cosplayers, and I'm just so happy that she
And she's
that.
So nice that she even, like, put the cosplay contest together.
You're just trying to get me mad about someone that I think is just, like, fucking hot? She's like, she looks great, she wears fucking PJs.
That camera's about to go in the microwave.
I was hoping they would do all of my dirty work for me. Now I now actually have to do the research. I have to
do your job.
Google.
Oh God. Okay.
Emeru. Okay. Where's it at?
Trusty old Wikipedia. Emeru started streaming on Twitch November 2016, playing League.
Yeah.
I should have just started with that. Maybe I should check out the other judges just in case. Emeru, Tectone.
Why are you clicking on me, bro? This is an Emmy video. What are you doing?
Who's that?
Bro. What are you doing, bro?
Oh, Ashman Gold! Nice!
Oh my god, bro.
Oh my god!
Oh my god. She's so perfect, bro.
What are you doing, man? She's AI, okay? What, man? What? She's an AI girl. Chill, bro.
Boldy.
There's an Emmy video, but dog. You, come on.
Please be advised that this was all scripted. Thank you. Sorry.
You don't do it in the video where you just say hello, Neptune, and laugh to yourself. I will not do this. I will refuse.
I don't even have him plugged in. Nope. It's just for the video.
I can't hold in the laugh.
So this is what happens whenever a wholesome person tries to start drama?
Yep.
Oh my god.
You couldn't say nothing bad about Emmy besides League?
I mean,
it's bad enough.
It is pretty bad.
I wanted to see more cutthroat drama inducing moments, bro. You went to me, bro. Come on, man.
Well, with you, it's natural.
Whoa, my god. That's the point, right? You had Emmy was somebody you had to get in there. You had to make her insecure, but you went the safe route and you took
right,
a shot at me.
All right, chill.
Okay.
This is what I think. You want to know my honest, actual opinion?
Yes, let's go.
I think that, number one, the video title and the thumbnail were S tier. The fact that you actually reached out and collabed with other people for the video was beyond S tier. That's more work than most people put into their actual streams. So I think that if you put all of those things together, like, you didn't know, like, the thing is, like, you don't have a rapport with Emeru. Like, you might not really be in the same type of vibe that other people are with, like, roasting and shit like that. So, like, maybe you don't want to go as far because you don't know what's going to be offensive, what's not. Because, you know, maybe as a girl, you could have things that make you insecure and you wouldn't want to hit on one of those insecurities for Emmy for a more empathetic reason. So whenever I contextualize what you're saying and what you're doing around all of those other things, it makes
makes sense to me why you did the video you did. So I'm not even really going to grade the video based off of what, you know, like what was in the video. It's necessarily like what went into the video. And I actually think that, you know, again, based off the title, thumbnail, and the fact that the collabing and like also the premise of the video, was great. I liked it a lot. I was really happy to see it.
Yeah.
even though you totally pussied out on roasting her.
Well, no. I thought in the second part you're about to start going in. Like, it's, you know, it's not your fault that the other contestants didn't want to do the dirty work. I mean, I don't go into a roast expecting them to be like, oh, she's nice. Oh,
yeah,
she's hot. Like,
but
I thought I was about
like
to
that,
cry.
Right? That's the
right,
thing.
Right, yeah,
like,
so
well,
it's hard. Yeah. It's hard. But I thought it was a good
parody
video, good
of a roast.
Yeah. Oh, parody of a roast.
Kind of, yeah. It's because all the things I was going to roast you for, I do the same thing.
I feel like that's even better.
That's fine. Dude, who doesn't love
a
hypocrite? Bro, I love that. Yeah, it's the truth. But yeah, missed skill shots. I mean, good job on your entry, and we'll see what happens.
Thank you.
Of course.
Thank you very much.
So what'd y'all think?
I was really impressed by that. Oh, I was lying to her. It was terrible. We're going to fail her for sure.
Oh, yeah, no, 100%.
Oh, of course, yeah, I was totally lying. I was just trying to be nice. But no, like, for real, though, like, what I said, like, I feel like is 100% true. Like,
I feel...
Effort, like, I am I crazy? Like...
Oh, no, like, I mean, she put in a lot of effort. I think it was effort in the wrong areas, me personally. Like, I feel like she had an assignment to roast Emmy, didn't do it. That's how
so
I
like,
feel
let,
about
let's
it.
Go ahead. Let's draw a parallel, right? So remember last time whenever Suncracker did that one episode where, like, he didn't even react to the video, he just started talking shit about me? Did you see that? Well, that's what he
did.
And so, like, the thing is that it's like whenever you can't play to your strengths, you change the game. Whenever you can't play to what you're good at, you don't necessarily need to play that game. And the fact that she was confident enough to change it and do her own thing, etc., and like all of the other like intangible work factors were actually like S tier, even though the roast was bad. The roast isn't necessarily the point. The roast is just the conduit to accentuate the person's talent.
The
and
point is the
willing.
Content and the personality. So.
That's so true. That's exactly what I was gonna say.
Yeah, she's a sweet person. Like maybe if she tried to be mean, it would have just come across as really awkward and weird. So maybe she made the right choice. You know,
I feel like that's definitely a take that you can have. But I mean, for previous like episodes, I mean, people like Navius, for example, you know, they tried to do what was required. They even pivoted and they got punished for that. I don't think it would be fair for me to say that it'd be okay to pivot like that. Me personally, so personally,
that's
I'm grading her what her assignment was.
It's not about what the pivot is. It's about whether you try to do it or not. She knew that she wasn't going to do that, and so she just changed the game on her own. It's the difference between taking initiative and then not taking initiative and letting somebody else write the script for you.
Interesting take.
Yeah.
Well, I think the votes are in for... Actually, no, chat needs to vote on the next video, right? Or is the poll already done? All right, so who won the poll for the second one? Okay, so chat, place your votes for what video you want to see next. Me, personally, I would like to see Sunny's video, personally. I would like to see me get ripped to shreds. I would like someone to go in on the streamer.
I kind of want to see the Nick one. I'm just curious because of the title. It's a little weird of a title. But...
yeah. Who do you want to see, Asmund?
What?
Which video do you want to say?
I don't care. I'll watch whichever one. We're going to watch all of them anyway.
That's
true. All I do is react to videos. It doesn't matter. It's not a matter of if. It's a matter of when.
I feel like the one that we just saw would probably be the nicest one. But I would hopefully we go on here and we get real uncomfortable and we get real heated.
Okay.
But I do agree to play to your strengths for when you stream. I totally get that.
Yep. That's why I don't play a lot of games.
Yeah. Well, the results are in. Let's see what chat wants to say. And chat wants to see Mayor Wurtz. Whose video was Mayor Wurtz? Which one was that?
You guys, man. Oh, my God. Who you think is about?
Wait, is that the Asmund one?
Of course it is.
Okay. Okay.
Y'all, all right. I'm ready to fucking see this shit. No, I'm ready. I'm 100% ready to see this. I want to know what you got in store for me.
Oh, the good. Tears! Oh. I couldn't even see the tears when the thumbnail was small. It's a nice touch.
I think this is a really good thumbnail because it maximizes the amount of Asmund in the thumbnail, not once, but twice.
Well, it also, like, what I like about this too is it capitalizes on a meme that both uses, like, it's like fans of like my stream and also hate watchers. Like, any hate watcher would watch this.
That's true. The react is really good too. Nice white, the like little white drop shadow behind Mayorworks to make you pop. Yeah. The little outline for the font as well. I would have gone with yellow or red font because that's the two colors that are most appealing to the eye. But this is a damn good thumbnail, man. This is a damn good thumbnail.
The only thing I would say is like criticism on this would be like the picture of me with hair, the small picture, is too small to see. You wouldn't know what the fuck that is.
Yeah,
on like
the
a
bottom
phone.
Right,
that's
text
fair
too.
Yeah,
that's fair.
The bottom right text is just them putting it in there.
Yeah. Oh, that's okay, cool. Okay, that's part of the overlay.
Yeah. All right, Mayorworks. So I want to know how in do you go in this video? If you were to say from 1 to 10,
I think, you know what. Let's just go with an 8.35.
Okay.
I think that's a fair amount.
Okay.
All right.
Then why don't we go ahead and roll the video then? Let's see what Mayorworks has for us today. That's a strong start.
I'm never gonna tell you on his hairline!
Okay.
There comes a time in everyone's life when they are thrown into something so critically important that not only does it change themselves, but society as a whole. This week, I've been called upon to answer one specific question. What happened to Asmund Gold's hairline? I got an email with a clip late one night from someone who wishes to remain anonymous. Warning, this video may be disturbing to anyone who is prone to crying.
Oh my god, what is that, bro? What is that?
Oh, what? What's wrong?
My hair wet.
After reviewing the clip, I noticed three very important things. One, he is using Redken shampoo. Two, he is showering outside, gross, with Texas water. And three, he is not paying for Streamlabs premium. I mean, let's be honest, it's really not that expensive. Things were starting to make sense, but only a little bit of sense. So I decided to talk to some very important people about the clip. Okay. I decided to reach out to someone who used to work at the Austin, Texas water plant, Dean Pants.
Yeah, you know, the water in Texas has always been a problem. I mean, look at me.
Dean Pants?
You know what? This interview's over. That's it. We're done here.
After that, I met with Redken shampoo representative Judy Jeans to get her take on the matter.
Here at Redken, we believe in maintaining the hairline for everyone. However, I want to make it very clear that we do not at all endorse Asmund Gold and his use of our product. He showers outside. Gross.
I also reached out to Streamlabs, who sent me one of their
interns.
Unfortunately, due to budget, I wasn't able to fly them out.
Wait, you interviewed everybody else in person, but you couldn't afford me? You at least buy me Streamlabs Pro? You seem like a pretty cheap journalist.
All of my sources were proving to be unsuccessful in my search of the hairline in rapid decay. I attempted to reach out to additional informants, but not even my own mother was taking my calls. I felt lost. That was until yesterday.
I can tell you everything you need to know about Asmund Gold's hairline.
We gotta go.
Did you come alone? That's fine. Now, where and why are you? Oh boy. Let's talk hairline.
After I saw some of the pictures, my source thought I was with the government and got spooked.
You with the government? I'll never tell you about his hairline! Never! I'm never telling you about his hairline! I'm never gonna tell you about his hairline! Wait, why are you so interested in Asmund Gold's hairline? Look at yourself.
What do you mean?
When's the last time you looked at your own hairline?
Oh, no.
My source was right.
No.
My hairline was also receding. Picture after picture telling a story of what I was and what I would become. Was I the thing I was searching for? A monster? Look
at
me.
No. No.
Yeah. There it is.
Oh, shit.
I made one of those last night. That's not enough. That's good.
Just look at me.
Oh, God.
Holy shit, this is crazy.
What the fuck?
That's crazy. No, no.
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, that's bad. Oh, bro, he is down bad. Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God.
So the hairline was inside you all along.
Dude.
That's correct. That's correct.
Wow. That was a good one.
Amazing.
That was really good.
Thank
I liked
you.
It a lot.
Dude. Okay, holy shit, I have so much to say. First of all, there's a damn good reason you've been here since episode one. That was incredible. The storytelling, the callbacks, the pivot, that is exactly what I wanted this show today to be about. That was
wonderful.
Perfect. Even, dude, the interviews, the way you present yourself, the pacing, I wouldn't have changed a goddamn thing. That was incredible.
Thank you so much.
Of course. Emmy,
I think the end part, I guess this is Emmy's turn, so I'll just start
no,
talking.
No, you go ahead. You go
so,
ahead.
No, that's why I figured, yeah. And, I liked it. I thought it was really good. I the end part was really clever. I didn't expect it at all, and that was probably my favorite part. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, I liked how it wasn't mean. You kind of just took one joke that's like a joke in his community and you turned it into like a whole cinematic thing that was very interesting to watch. I assume that the other actors were like your friends. I thought that they all did a really good job too and added a lot to the video. It was just cool. Really good video.
Thank you. Thank you.
Out of curiosity, did you edit that yourself or did you hire an editor? It's fine if you didn't.
No. I edit videos. That's all my editing.
That dude, good shit, man. Like, good shit.
Thank you.
You should be incredibly proud of yourself. Like, that was awesome.
Thank you very much. I am. I'm very happy about this video. Asmin, I hope you understand what I had to do. I do have WoW installed now on my computer. So
wow. So you really went all the way for this one, huh?
I went all the way.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I'll survive. Yeah.
Wow.
All right, well, Mayor Wirtz, you did an amazing job, at least in my opinion. We'll see how you do when we have to go to the voting section. But, we'll see you soon.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Holy shit.
That was a really good one. I liked it a lot.
Like, was that...
Editing
that
was so good.
Like, that is exactly what I wanted to say. Like, that was good shit.
Yeah, I think that was really, really good.
Wow. All right, well, chat, I mean, we just saw that. Which one do y'all want to see next? We have some very good ones up to bat, but yeah, make sure to get your votes in so that way we can watch what y'all want to see. Wow. I'm taking it back, man. That was just entertaining.
You're just,
I'm glazing
you're
a little
you're
bit.
Just thinking about it?
Yeah, I'm glazing a little bit too hard.
What the hell does glazing even mean?
Slorp glorpin.
What the hell does slorp glorpin even mean?
Cranking the shaft, milking the gravy.
Oh.
There you go. Yeah, you get that one.
Yeah, I get it. All right, now I understand. Yeah, no, I thought it was really good. I'm excited to see what the next ones are going to be. Honestly, like, I feel like this is a situation. You ever been in school and, like, you go, you got to do your presentation, and then the person before you does a really good presentation, and yours is fucking garbage, and you're, like, fucking stressed out because, like, comparatively, yours looks way worse?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of how I would feel if I were the other contestants, man. I feel like these past two videos have been really good. Like, by the way, anybody that's still in school, listen, I got a bit of a tip. You want to wait till the stupid kid does his presentation, and then you volunteer to go after him. That way you get points for initiative, and you can also farm the comparative advantage that you're going to have over him.
You know what's the scariest thing? You wait for the stupid kid to go up, and then they never go up, and then you realize that you're the stupid kid.
Everybody's waiting for you.
Yeah, it's the worst. Right. Well, I believe the poll results are up. Who are we watching next, guys? Let's see here. Sun Crackers video. I think
that's yours.
Was, Yeah, that's me.
That's
okay.
You. You're next.
What could he possibly have to say negative about me, man? I mean, that's crazy. Yo, Sonny, what up?
Yo, what's up? I think I'm about to find out that I'm the stupid kid.
Okay. Okay.
Didn't know we were making documentaries. I thought it was just like a streamer roast video.
Yeah, well, I mean, we'll have to see. I mean, this is OTK Elevator. This is a big shot, man. People went all out. But we'll
you
find out.
Named this, you should have named this title, I Lost My Hair.
True. He is bald.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I want to clarify. I'm shaved. Okay, I'm not bald. I could grow my hair. I choose not
you
to.
You shouldn't, though.
No, I mean, somebody's got to do it. You know what's crazy is that 1 in 3 men experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they're 30, right?
Well, I've got two brothers, so I'll let them take the bad look.
Okay. Well, you want to give us any type of info before we get into this video, or you want to just roll the footage?
This is your classic Twitch streamer's YouTube video. I'll just say that. It's not like a YouTuber's YouTube video, if you know what
so
I mean.
So it's like fucking garbage.
Yeah, man, you get it.
Okay, all right, I got it.
Okay, well, let's just go ahead and see the video. Let's see what you did, buddy.
Let's look. Tectone gets emotional and cries on stream. Says OTK is the only positive thing.
Oh, my God.
I was doing research, and turns out 80% of you did not vote for me. Now, you held up your end of the bargain. You put me through another week, so I didn't have to break your ankles by throwing out of my third-story window. But I have a new offer for you. If I make it to the finals, not even win on the show, I can just make it to the finals. I have just gotten a job at my local Walgreens, and I start in a few weeks. So if I make it to the finals, I won't need a job at Walgreens. I will IRL stream me walking in and quitting on my first day on the job, and you, the Twitch chat, will get to vote for my outfit. Now, chat, you might be asking, why am I going to be mean to Tectone today? Well, I've learned from previous episodes that every contestant Tectone likes gets kicked the next episode. First Navius.
Not true.
Now Oofy.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do my best to make sure that Tectone doesn't like me. So we're not just going to roast Tectone today. We're exposing that egghead finally. Let's get on the proper gear.
Okay.
The right gear.
And lastly.
Nice little transition.
Okay. I'm going to be honest with you guys. This didn't take a lot of effort on my part. I opened Tectone's stream the moment I got this challenge to kind of get a vibe of the man I'm making fun of. Tectone, buddy? Bro? Pal? Take a look. I opened Tectone's stream right after the show.
She has two Tectone heads worth of honkers, my goodness.
Look at him! Mouth agape. Facial hair askew. Dome bulging. It looks uncomfortable. Dude, he is shocked by
who
everything
is it,
somehow larger than his head. Tectone looks like the lost third titty.
Nice.
You did not just say Tectone sent me here.
No, he wanted okay, that. What does he mean like, oh, what?
Oh, wait, no, that's
she knows
that's the
that I'm sending all this support? Oh, gosh. Oh, whatever, dude. Why is his head so large? He looks like one of the thumbs from, like, Spy Kids 3D. Or no, Spy Kids 3D,
God.
Right? The Thumbians? God, he's like the inverse of Hassan. Have you guys seen... Hold on, let's pull up Hassan. If you just take Hassan's build and you swap... Oh, dude, he heard me. He knew. He could feel himself being judged. Are you saying Genshin is the opposite of politics? Yes. It's so weird that he, like, does this whole egg bit on stream. If he's an egg, oh my god, I don't want to see that omelet. Then I saw this.
What do you mean by that, bro?
Let me introduce my crew. Dead 1, Dead 2, Dead 3, and Petra.
I'm the only one everyone cares about because I'm a cute girl.
What about her?
Titans make me horny.
True.
Did I just hear that correctly?
Not to that.
Look at him. There's no... Oh my god. Why does he look like that? He looks like an inverted circumcised penis with that beanie. Let's see how Mr. Inverted
What's
Penis
that
over
goatee?
Here. Inverted Hassan.
You don't like that? I think it's
a
clean.
Children's game.
No.
No. You just jump. Did he break his controller? Dude, he was with young. He failed young Jefferson. Young Jeffrey, you do not deserve this. I will get you a crown any day of the week. Let's Google him. This is the guy that would yell at the entire class for playing their trumpet wrong and get super offended on behalf of the band teacher. You know who I'm talking about? This is the ultimate teacher defender. Before he was defending PNGs, he was defending every teacher from no threat that existed. I ate shrimp and it was nice. I love shrimp. Speaking of shrimp, his shoulders. Dude, what's this main one? Is he crying? Why does he look like that? Dude, at least he got some hearts. That's pretty cool. Ah, damn. That's his number one picture. Wait, he had hair? Oh, you know what?
I think the bald thing is working. You know what? I think he should grow hair. I think he wore his beanies too tight. You know what I mean? He definitely looks like he wore them too tight and it just like peeled his scalp back. Dude, actually, yeah, let's see what other small streamers think of this guy. Hold on.
Stop. Oh my god.
Stop it! She's not even doing anything! She's just existing! What looks smoother, his head or the breast?
Yo, this fool is judging. Should I be worried?
I would not worry at all. Bro, look at his hairline.
Oh my god, bro.
This is a great point.
Do you feel me? Listen, at the end of the day, if he's mad, just be like, you're bald. I'm not.
Are you? Why?
Dude, he was scared to even watch Tektone on stream. People just assume Tektone stream is TOS. Dude, small streamers have spoken. Now, I decided I had had enough of this guy and decided to go watch my good friend Navius's channel for much better content. And wouldn't you know who would show up there? Let's check the logs. Let's check the vaunts. This was him. This was Tektone in Navius's chat right after the show. Jet Set Radio is soft fucking sick. Dude can't even give him the respect to type out a message correctly. He is farming dick tones and even the smallest streamers' chats.
I don't think you're as bad as everyone thinks you are.
I bet if you went to Navius, he wouldn't say this today. What can I say? I'm a great guy.
True.
Who says that? He wanted the attention back. Wait. Yeah, true, I'm sick. But believe me, I'm much worse than they say. I don't know if he's got a rap sheet, but he might have a rap sheet. He might be stealing illegal black tar dome injections. That's right. Moments after giving Navius hundreds of viewers, Tektone realized he wanted them back. He couldn't stand to have less viewers. He had to go into Navius's chat and immediately start leeching. Now, I know what you're thinking, Suncracker, you're starting drama. If there's a fire, where's the smoke? Listen, if that's not enough and you guys think I'm just starting drama, here's the man himself sharing what Tektone did to him.
You know how Tektone reached out to me about a collab with him last week? He was talking about how his numbers have been really, really low lately, and it would really help him out. I decided to give him a shot. We set something up, and the next day, he asked if I could give him a raid, so I did. And later that same day, I got a flat tire. God. So I let him borrow mine. And the day after that, as soon as I got eliminated from the competition, he blocked me on everything. And I was just trying to help him out.
Lastly, unlike Tektone, here are a few actual jokes that I was original enough to come up with myself rather than stealing from other small streamers. Why is your name Tektone, when we can all agree there is nothing technical about your tone at all? If we're talking about the tone of your voice, you sound like a worse Austin show on a somehow worse Blue Yeti mic than his Middle Eastern friend used to use. If we're talking about skin tone, though, there's still nothing technical. According to Lowe's Color Picker, you are eggshell white. You are somehow whiter than me, and I'm literally named Suncracker. Apparently my time's almost up, so here's one more. Why did Tektone cross the road? I wonder, chat. Well, I have the answer. To replace Schlatt as the OTK member with the worst facial hair. My mom once said I looked like a misshapen vagina, but your goatee matches the business end of my toilet brush. Matter of fact, let's get some images up. Now, I know what you're thinking. These are the same image. Nope. That's Tektone. That's the toilet brush. If this doesn't convince you all that Tektone is actually Dicktone, and it's not a bit, I don't know what will. Suncracker 2023. Let's see how this Walgreens job goes.
Are you actually going to live stream you quitting Walgreens?
Oh, yeah. No. Genuinely, they just sent me the HR paperwork. It's on my desk right now.
Oh, that's sick. Wow. Hey, man, you went the fuck in.
Listen, they said the goal was to do YouTube and be a dick. And now, after seeing the other contestants, I'm somehow worried I was too mean.
No, dude. Hey, it's all good,
man. You
followed
the assignment. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That was a roast. That was the most roast of all the ones so far.
And plus, the other thing, it's okay to be a dick to me. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, that's what's... Dude, whenever I found out I got Tektone, I went, okay, all bets are off. He gets it.
You went in. I applaud you, dog. I thought that was good.
I thought it was really good. I liked it a lot. Especially the part where you shouted yourself out at the end. I really like that.
Oh, you gotta do it.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, the call with Navius too, that was good.
Dude, Navius has been, dude, best contestant. If there's some way we can bring him back on here, we gotta make it happen.
You wanna give him your spot?
Well, no, I don't like him that much. He's okay. I don't know.
Maybe he's all right. You don't want him on that bad.
Nah.
Okay, I get that. Emmy, what'd you think? Emmy?
Sorry.
What'd you think of the video?
I thought that it was good, but I thought the strongest part was the beginning, and like towards the middle it started to feel a little bit long, and then kind of got my attention again with the naviest part. So I would say I thought it was good, but needed a little bit of work. Like it didn't feel engaging throughout the whole thing, but it was good. It met the assignment really well.
Fair point.
I think the only thing I wish you went a little bit, I mean, this is just me though. I wish you went a little bit harder, you know, like I was expecting like the bald, you know?
Right.
I liked the shit facial hair from Shrek. Right. That was a good one. That was a good callback. But I mean, I think he got in there. But yeah. Cool. Well, good job on the video.
I liked it. I thought it was funny. And again, I think that the best part was the fact that it was definitely, you were 100% right, a Twitch streamer's YouTube video.
Right.
Yeah.
I thought it was perfect. Yeah. I even liked at the beginning, right? You stole it from Emmy, right? Where you just randomly cut your video to like plug something totally random.
I tried to
totally
hit all the
random
main points.
Yeah, yeah. Watching that was good.
All right. Well, yo, dude.
Yeah.
Sonny, good video, man. And we'll see what happens next time we see you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you guys so much.
Cool.
Cool.
It was definitely, I think it was definitely. I think the idea was good. I think farming the bald, you know, loud is good. I was hoping to see a little bit more. You know, when you compare it to other videos, it is very, you know, he has some stiff competition for sure. Also, by the way, guys, we have a poll up to vote up for the next video for that y'all want to see. But yeah, I mean, it was a little bit low effort, but I feel like the content was there. What do you think?
It felt a bit slow in some parts. That's the main criticism that I have. But it was a roast.
Yeah, it was.
A couple good jokes.
Yeah.
I would say that's about right, too. Yeah, and it's also like it's just him on his stream, too, talking besides, like, I think the part where he had Navius on. So I thought it was clever. Yeah, decent enough, I would say, overall.
I think it would farm, too. You know, people probably took the Navius bit seriously. Like,
yeah.
Actually DM'd him to get a raid. That was good. That'll definitely cause some drama. That'll be good.
Oh, yeah.
I was hoping there would be like fake screenshots and that shit, but unfortunately my stream is so fucking weird that he didn't need it. He just was actually able to use real clips.
Yeah, you just got to use facts.
That's all you need. Yourself. Yeah.
Yeah, 100%, man, 100%. Yeah, well, the poll results are in. We're going to see what video we're watching next, and we're actually watching Mr. Fimple. And I think Mr. Fimple got who? NMP, maybe? I'm actually not sure. I guess we'll find out in a sec. Why don't we go ahead and pull Mr. Fimple in?
Okay.
Yeah, oh. Fimple with NMP. This is going to be good.
Oh, hi, guys. Are you trying to get canceled, Tecto?
What up?
Right, what do you mean?
You're like, what? I hope he fakes screenshots. Like, what are you looking for? Tecto wants this to be his last stream. That's crazy.
Yeah. Hey, man, dude, if I get canceled, then I can just go on vacation, man. It'll be great.
Yeah, right. There you go.
True, yeah.
Yeah, so are you excited for this one, man? How'd it go going in on NMP? I feel like that's a pretty easy target.
It's an easy target, but a lot of people don't want to see NMP on their screen, so it's kind of a hard thing, you know?
That's your viewer attention might be pretty low, but
yeah.
I'm assuming
I tried to be as creative as I could. I tried to be as creative as I could with it. I'll say that much.
Okay. Well, I'm excited. Do you want to go ahead and roll the video, or is there anything else you want to say before we roll it?
Enjoy, you know, sit back, relax, have a blast.
Okay.
All right.
Well, let's see the video, guys.
Let's get it.
Congratulations on going to the next round. We'll see you guys. See you tomorrow. And thank you for participating today.
Emily,
hope you enjoyed the sturdy, Emily. I know you voted no, but I hope you enjoyed the sturdy.
Oh, your sturdy was good, by the way.
I voted no because I was jealous of your sturdy.
I practiced it all night in the shower, genuinely. I knew it was going to come up, so I was in there like for at least an hour and a half.
Wait. While you were taking a shower?
No, I got a ring cam set up, and if you want, I can send you the footage, Nick.
Oh, God. What the hell? Oh no.
sucks.
Oh god.
Oh, hello? No. Somebody there?
Hey, it's Kelly. Sorry I can't come to the phone right now. Unless you're Fimple, leave me a message after the tone.
Oh my God.
Is that a hockey jersey? Hello? Who's up there? Just seems like something's going on here.
Dude, you sound insane.
I know. There's no way he's here, but it's just I'm seeing things and...
Exactly. You sound insane. Oh, Nick is a glorified man-child. You heard Caroline. His place even stinks. Why would he be chasing down you?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, it's just, you know, with Elevated and I'm just stressed.
Trust me. Nick should be more worried about tracking down that receding hairline than chasing some random dude he doesn't even know.
Yeah, no, I mean, yeah, you're probably right.
I am right.
Thompson P., private investigator. Yeah, I know. I was the one who called you here? Yeah, well, it's just part of the, you think somebody's living here with you? Yeah. Here, let me show you around.
Wait, were those the keys to his GTR?
Huh.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
No dust. What? This Nick guy, is he allergic to a lot? Actually, yeah, I think he is. He's a very sensitive guy. He's basically allergic to everything. Somebody was sitting right there. You mean that chair? No. There. Oh my God. That makes so much sense. You got a stepbrother? No, just a stepsister. Well, then somebody brought this here. That's him. This is where I keep hearing the noise from. But you went up there? This NMP guy. You think he's dangerous? No, not really. Worst thing that happens, he gets tilted at Apex and talks about us on his alt. Well, I think we go up there. Jesus Christ. It's a mess up here.
It's cold.
Yeah, this is... I don't know, I got a bad feeling up here. Man, seems like the only way this guy's staying survived is piggybacking off soda.
Dude, what a video, man.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
I got a lot to say, but Emmy or Asmund, feel free to go first, because I have a lot to say.
The soda joke, I don't know how I didn't see that coming. I was like, cola? Does Nick drink that? I did not realize that. That was so good.
Yeah, I felt like we had the visual part of the video, so I tried making the roast as visual as possible to really capitalize on it being a video.
Yeah, I used your strengths. It was good. Really cool.
I loved it. I really did. I think that, like, especially the, like, just, like, the camera work and everything about it, like, all the intangibles and things that you don't really think about unless you make videos, those were all S tier. I was really impressed. And, yeah, the jokes were very good.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, I spent a long time on it.
So, like, I won a lot of creativity in this. Like, once again, you and Mayor Wirtz, like, delivered videos exactly how I wanted them to be. Like, good roast, but also a lot of things and good fun. I also loved how, like, the insults, like, they weren't in your face. Like, if you got it, you got it. Like, that's this, also the cinematography was also great. Did you record that yourself, or who recorded that for you?
Yep, it was me, and then my sibling Aaron helped as well, but I did all the lighting and stuff myself, yeah.
And, like, even when you were, like, it was very immersive because, like, you would even show, like, the shoulder of you, even though it was you as the only actor. So good. Jokes were good. Yeah. Roast were good. It was in good fun, but it was also, like, you know, like, calling him out on the fence sitting. Oh, my God. Damn good.
I mean, the truth, you know, got to peek through.
Yeah. I mean, goddamn, man. Great job.
Thank you. I appreciate it, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
It was super fun.
Yeah, awesome. Well, Mr. Fimple, we'll see you in a little bit, and we'll see how you did. We'll see what chat thinks, but yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Cool.
I think that might be my favorite one.
I was going to say the same thing. I think that's my favorite so far.
Yeah. That was dangerous. Also, guys, make sure to vote on the polls. It'll be the last vote that y'all do. For which one you'll see second to last. That was insane. I mean, obviously, I think NMP is probably one of the easier targets to get in there. And, you know, the fence sitting, the feet, but the way that it was presented was just amazing. It was just good. So I'm excited to see these last two. And, you know, some of the contestants really set the bar high. Like, they set the bar high.
I'm excited to see what they're going to come up with. I really am. I think that especially that one, like the cinema, like just like the camera work and everything. It was just crazy. Like, what the hell, man? It didn't look like just a video a guy filmed in his house.
It looked very professional.
It's also like, you know, I think that there's an element of confidence whenever you're willing to show and not tell. With like jokes and stuff like that, and just like expect the audience to get it, and I definitely appreciate that. Like, I'm gonna be totally real. I didn't get the soda joke until Emmy brought it up.
Really?
I was like, wow, Nick must be really fat if he's drinking that much soda.
Oh, I got it immediately. I was like, soda in the attic. Okay, dude.
Yeah,
like,
I didn't even think of it at all.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? Like. And I just want to say, like, they found out about this last week. Like, the amount of effort that some of the contestants are putting in. Like, I want to make sure that we get some, like, hearts and, like, easy claps in chat for some of the contestants. Because, like, they're putting in a lot of work, guys. This is hard stuff. They are busting their ass because this means a lot to them. And it's just, it's really nice to see. Like, you know, as much as I want to go on stream and be a dick, like, we have to give them their credit because these people are trying really hard, guys. And it's a very beautiful thing to see. I'm very proud of a lot of the contestants. Like, very, very, very good. Very cool. But, I mean, the poll results are up. Let's see what video we're watching next. Second to last, we have Evan Gao, the professional Minesweeper player. Let's go ahead and pull him in here and let's see that video. Evan, yo.
Yo.
You are second to last. How are you feeling, man? You excited to show us what you did?
I feel like I'm about to be sandwiched in between two great videos.
What are you saying about yours, man? You're not confident? You got this?
I thought mine was like amazing, and then I saw everyone else's. I was like, wow, these people went all out. Like, the cinematography in the last one was crazy, and the lighting, like, look at my lighting. I'm living in an attic. How do I even compare, you know?
Well, what are you trying to say? He's saying you can't have good video in an attic?
No, I think you can have a good video in an attic. I shot my entire video on a phone.
Yeah, I agree. So true.
I think I have the scuffed charm.
Okay. I don't want you. I learned this in acting class. Don't point out your own flaws. Let other people figure it out, because we might not even notice. We might think it's amazing. So, you know, believe in yourself, man. You got this. You're going to do great, I'm sure.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Well, then let's go see that video. Let's see what Evan did for us, guys. Let's see.
If Emiru's voice were any more strained and gravelly, she'd be yesterday's coffee grounds. And hey, what's with your weird obsession with Kirby anyways? You're not a 12-year-old girl from Kansas anymore. You're a 25-year-old streamer in Austin, which is somehow worse. Maybe the reason she always...
Evan, that's Emiru. You're supposed to be roasting extra Emily.
Who?
Dude, I didn't escape her today. I just got roasted.
Excuse me, sir?
Yeah?
Yeah, are you busy?
No.
Okay, I'm doing like an interview type thing, so do you have some time to answer a few questions?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Do you know of Extra Emily from OTK?
Yeah, the streamer?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
You know.
Yes, okay. Yes.
What are your opinions of her?
I've watched quite a few streams of hers, actually. Her IRL streams have... so much, like, she's so confident. I think it's amazing. She's super bubbly and nice. She's a great time to watch.
All right, well, thank you for your input.
Yeah, of course.
Yo, thank you so much for saying that, man.
Yeah, of course, dude. This is not enough. I look way too nice.
Fine. Fair enough.
Thanks, dude. Thanks.
Wait, was this thing on?
So do you think?
Hi, welcome to Citibank. Oh, no. How can I help you today?
I'm actually here to ask about Extra Emily.
Extra Emily? I haven't seen her in a minute, but I loved her content. Now, when she had her subathon going on, I watched it 24/7. I told everyone in the office about it. Whatever happened to her anyway? I haven't seen her in a bit.
Damn.
Have you heard of OTK?
Oh my god, I love OTK. Michael and Lily are so cute.
Have you ever heard of Extra Emily from OTK?
Is she the one that talks to birds?
No, that's Maya.
My bad. She's the one that sucks at League, right?
No, that's Emiru.
My bad. She's the one that cheated on schools.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Yeah, that does sound right.
All right,
guys, I think I got everything I need. Now it's time to go home and edit.
Ooh, it's like a little montage. Nice touch.
Got it.
You know, when I was 5, I started playing the piano, but I quit when I was 8. Unlike Extra Emily, who went on to win multiple high school competitions, yeah, that's right. Okay. We all know that Extra Emily is musically talented. But you know what she isn't? Bad at academics. Yeah, that's right. In 2016, she was a part of the All-Nebraska academic team at her high school. Crazy. What? Hey, Extra Emily, what's it like to graduate summa cum laude from Columbia University, one of the most prestigious universities in the entire world? Meanwhile, I'm over here getting massive depressive episodes and withdrawing from UC Berkeley, and I'm still struggling to graduate, and it fucking sucks. You fucking idiot!
You're so fucking stupid, Emily.
Did you hear that Emily got the cops called on her recently? It was for being too nice. Roasted! Hey, Emily, what's it like to get partner after streaming for less than 1 year? Yeah. Twitch, please, let me be partner. I've been trying so hard, and why did you deny me the first time? I'm a good streamer, I swear. I'm really good. God, imagine winning a $50,000 OTK tournament. Legitimately. Oh wait, Extra Emily already did that. If Extra Emily was any more bubbly, she'd be a can of LaCroix!
Nice transition.
Wait, Evan, these aren't roasts. They're all just compliments. And what happened to our background? What about the video's continuity?
Oh, we forgot to film this part.
I think you need to do a little bit more research.
Okay. I'll get back to it then.
Okay.
You know, Extra Emily and I are not so different. We both leached off of bigger streamers who then went on to get canceled. I got it. Omaha, more like Nomaha. What do you call a Nebraskan who watches Fox News? A conservative. Corn Huskers. I hardly know her. What's so great about Omaha, Nebraska? It's the only place in the world that starts with a sigh and ends with a laugh. Get it? Cause Omaha.
That was really funny, Chat. But you know what's not funny? A gambling addiction. Tectone. You gotta stop, man. You've pulled way too many times in Genshin. Like, come on, take a break.
What is happening?
Okay, back to the video.
The only famous person to come from Omaha, Nebraska is Warren Buffett. More like Borum Buffett. God, this shit just isn't working. What do I need to do to really make this come together?
Wait a minute. If I really want to roast Emily, I have to become Emily. Yeah.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
Is it working?
Don't tell me he's kayaking in a skateboard park.
Hello? Oh! Hi, chat! Oh my god, thank you both of these for the sub. Thank you so much. Guys, this is my first time here. I'm all dressed up for the occasion. Look at me, I'm so cool. Anyways, I'm about to go to Dave & Buster's. For the first time, surely nothing will go wrong. They kicked me out because I got too sturdy.
SQC loves me. SQC loves me. SQC loves me. Not copium, not copium.
Guys, I think I found one. Sir, have you heard of Twitch?
No.
It's this live streaming service. I'm actually live right now. Can we say hi to chat?
Hi, chat.
Can I smack your ass? All right, chat, that's it. See you later.
So how are you going to end your video?
What would Emily do?
Right and left. Hey, get dirty. Get dirty. Oh, so good. Okay.
Emily, if you're watching, they forced me to do it. I didn't want to. Okay, I'm sorry. I love you, and I want to play Minesweeper with you. Thank you for watching the video. Okay, thank you. Bye.
What a simp.
Yeah, bro, commit to it, man.
I never claimed to not be.
Oh, yep, okay. Oh my god. Dude, I think that was a good vid, man. I mean, you kind of lost me a little on the transitions, but I think they were a nice touch, but I don't think they were necessary, but it was still cool, you know what I mean? Like, putting a little bit extra effort into it, I think it was nice.
Yeah, the transitions are actually a clip from Emily's very first stream. Like, she did a woe for every single follow.
Oh, no, not that one. Like sorry, the montages. That shit was fucking hilarious. It reminded me a lot of the Andy Samberg roast.
I like the
transition. Yes. I was inspired by that.
Kind of all over the place.
Yeah, I picked up on that immediately.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good, man. It was good.
Thanks.
Yeah, I liked it. I thought it was clever. I mean, like, obviously, the thing is, if you go too hard into the anti-joke level, where, like, you're making fake jokes that are intentionally bad, I think it could be a little confusing, which it was at times. But other than that, it came together at the end pretty well. I like that.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, you came in here and you were saying, oh, I wasn't sure how I was going to do because I saw the video before. But honestly, man, I think you pulled out a good video, man. You should be proud of that.
Yeah, I filmed it all on my phone, so I'm pretty proud of it.
I mean, yeah, work with what you got, man. Good shit, dog. Well, I mean, yeah, good job. We'll see you again real soon. And yeah, good job out there.
Thank you, man.
Cool. I wasn't sure what to expect from that.
I didn't know what the fuck that video was. I'm gonna be real. Like, for the first half, like, it was like, it was going back and forth. Like, I didn't know if it was like real, if it was fake. I felt like I was watching Memento.
I don't even know what that is.
Okay.
What? Yeah, I don't even know what the hell that is. But yeah, like, I really liked how, like, self-aware it was, how there was a lot of layers to it, you know? Like, I just felt like, I don't know, it just felt natural, to me at least. Like, I really love that type of, like, intentionally cringe, intentionally uncomfortable stuff. Like, I thought it was good.
Mm-hmm. I liked it. But, I liked that style of video, too.
Yeah. All right, well, we have one video remaining with, I believe, it's Zion. So, yo, Zion, how you feeling, man?
I'm hyped. I can't wait for y'all to watch this. I'm actually, like, so pumped.
Cool. Are you excited to be last, or did you not like being last?
No, I'm actually, this is good. I'm excited to be last. I really think I put a together well-made video, and it took a whole team to do this. I'm pumped. I'm excited for y'all to watch this.
A whole team?
Whole team. Once you watch it, it'll make sense.
Okay, well, I mean, shit, then let's check it
out.
Well,
let's fucking watch it.
Yeah, last video, boys. Let's see it.
Welcome to De-Escalated.
What?
Starring your host,
what?
Zion K.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of De-Escalated, the show where smaller streamers roast to bigger streamers. I'm your host, Zion Cade. Today's episode, we have the famous Soda Poppin'. Sorry.
What is that?
Soda Poppin' couldn't be here today. He was too busy playing WoW. No worries. Soda Poppin's girlfriend is here tonight.
Boo!
So cringe, bro. Trash.
Oh, shit.
Everyone, welcome our first small streamer, Noah J. Wood. Tectone's a dick.
Oh my god, bro!
Yeah.
Whoa. Now that's not badass. Why do I still have this?
Alright, everyone. Next, we have a chat favorite. Everyone, put your hands together. For Navius!
Where the hell is Navius?
I don't know where he is.
Okay, alright, so it appears Navius is unavailable, but no worries, guys, it's okay. Next is an even better guest. Longtime friend of Soda Poppin', yes! Everybody, Jason Polam!
Oh, God.
Ah. Wow. I mean, what can I say? You know, me and Chance, we've been friends for a long time. I remember we moved to Austin together. I didn't even pay rent. I miss him.
Yeah.
I love him.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
So sad. Where'd he go, man?
Oh, fuck.
Do you or a loved one have low testosterone? Have you recently been diagnosed with TIS? Are you suffering from an aggressive form of hair loss? Or worse, have you lost her? If so, you may be eligible for financial compensation. Call the law offices of John Law at 1-800-TOUCH-GRASS. Thank you.
De-escalated!
Welcome everyone back to De-escalated. It's been a great night so far, but we're not done yet. Next up, we have another small streamer. Everybody, welcome to the podium, Jaden Moss!
Honestly, I don't watch this soda guy. The only GOAT streamer that I watch is Kai Sanat. Shout out W community. We're not cringe like the Poggers community. In chat, you a whole bitch!
Oh, hey man, can we keep the topic about soda?
You have 190 followers. Sit your ass down!
Damn, bro.
And since you want to talk so much, how are you putting this all on?
I know you're in debt. Starbucks is not paying for this. And
the people who follow you are not watching because of you. They're watching because of your hot wife. Because of your wife, not you. We have 190 followers, and only 10 of them watch. You suck! Hey! Ah!
Damn.
Which one's he going to eat first?
Wow. That was powerful. Well, anyways, we have another small streamer, the smallest one yet. Everybody, E-Rob!
I hate soda popping so much. I hate Chance.
Let's go. Thank you, everyone, for being here tonight. This has been another episode of De-escalated. Tune in next week.
So I really think this guy really channeled some really strong Mizkif vibes, because the majority of this video and the majority of the content wasn't even him.
Yeah, just somebody else, man.
Did you write the script, or was it all their own improv?
No, I wrote it. My wife, my brother, my brother, we all wrote it. Can you all hear me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can hear you.
Just checking. Yeah, I wrote the script. Yeah, completely. Yeah, all done. Me, assist. The minute we found out about, I was on a challenge last Thursday. My wife Erica, brother Zelid got the work. Wrote it. Friday finalized it. Saturday shot it, and then we finished it late yesterday.
I mean, I thought it was good, man. The callbacks were
bro, like that dude sitting in the chair, just sitting there talking shit. That was so fucking good, like, dude. So yeah, it was raw.
My thought was that Soda has been on this platform the longest, you know, before Twitch it was Justin TV. So
yeah.
I was like, bro, all the jokes said about him, I can't. This is so hard. I'm like, forget it. No one's safe. Everyone's getting roasted.
Yeah.
It wasn't like too hard, right?
What do you mean? It was too hard? Like, I give a fuck. I think that was great, man.
Sweet. All right.
Yeah, cool. It was great.
Yeah, it took a whole team to do that. Yeah, it's cool. Most of those people that helped with the camera, my brother, my wife, and I, we taught them. It's a whole team of friends that helped get this together.
That's good. You're lucky to have that, man. That's awesome.
Sweet. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thank you very much. Cool. That's all the videos.
Well, we got to think about this, right? I mean, I think we had some... I'm going to be real. Like, I thought these videos were going to be straight dog shit.
Yeah.
Like, that's what I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, and I was expecting...
I was expecting, like, cringe. Like, I was going to have to, like, at the end of this, I was going to have to, like, lay down for an hour after this because it was just going to be so fucking garbage. But these videos were way better than what I had expected. This is crazy. Yeah. Some tough competition going on in here.
I was expecting, like, 5 of 10 videos, you know, 5 out of 10s. Yeah. But, I mean, there were some 8s, there were some 9s, there were some 10s. I mean, that's some good shit. Like, I mean, yeah. I don't want to glaze too much, but, like, I mean, 2 of the videos for me were, like, insane. You know, I was very impressed.
Yeah, way better than what I would expect of a streamer.
I'm gonna go
those are like YouTuber level edits.
Exactly. Yeah, I would go so far even to say that it was lit. I would.
It was lit.
It absolutely was. I was really impressed by this. This was so fucking good, guys. Like, I think even the videos that I would say like maybe do not necessarily like make the cut, right? Like, I still think all of the contestants were really good. Like, the videos were funny. Like, there was, like, a lot of self-awareness. There's good camera work. Like, this is just way better than what I had expected. Like, I think that's what it comes down to.
Very difficult to judge these. Because like, I don't think we can let everybody through, but they were all good. So it's going to be rough.
Oh, come on, Emmy. Don't worry about it. Me and Tecton will take care of it. You can act like you didn't do nothing wrong, okay? Yeah, it's
what do you
fine.
We didn't do nothing wrong. Okay, well, I mean, you don't want to feel
bad
news.
For you don't. You don't want to feel bad for ranking somebody down.
It's no,
okay.
It's not we're that good. I feel bad. I just think that they all did a good job, even the ones that weren't as high quality. All
right, that's good enough.
It just depends how you go in with the mindset. For me personally, like I will be comparing like other people's entries to other people's entries because it's just about who wants it more. People who went the extra mile, who really like really got in there, and it looks like they cared. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, we're going to have to get down to one, right? That's the reality. And these people are competing against each other. So whether the entry was good is one thing, but it depends which one was the best, at least for me. Agree? Disagree?
Well, I was just thinking about, like, so if we had the final, like, imagine this, right? So, like, we could put everybody in an arena and blindfold them and give them, like, pool noodles. Like, you know, like a wooden bat with like a pool noodle around it so it doesn't hurt. And then just whoever is like the last man standing just wins.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking about. That's why I was thinking about something totally different. Like, I wasn't going to say that, but since you brought it up, like, I just figured I'd share what was going on in my head.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I think we should definitely do that.
So that's why I don't do production for the show. Because if it was, this would be Takashi's castle if it was me.
Yeah, you know what else would be me? Is a guy who would have a whole bunch of savings with comprehensive coverage. Progressive can bundle up your home and auto insurance for big savings and find out more at progressive.com. Thank you again, Progressive, for sponsoring Elevated. Very cool. Very, very cool. Very cool.
It's lit. Yeah, thank you very much, Progressive. Absolutely. Take a look at the link, and I think we're going to get everybody in here and take a look and get into the judging and all that. Does that sound about right, Tecton?
Yeah, contestants, welcome back, boys. Welcome back.
Hello.
It's time for my favorite part of the whole show. It's time to tell you how you did. I hope all you guys are feeling great and feeling proud of your submissions, but it's time for some real talk, boys. It's time for some real talk. Hope that doesn't scare you too much.
Well, nobody's hopefully fucking talking, so apparently nothing's real. Is that right? Okay, guys, I gotta say, you did fucking amazing. Everybody, I would say all 6 of you made videos that were, let's be real, on average better than most streamers' YouTube videos, including myself. So I really think it was great, and some people put a ton of work into the production, bringing other people on, that kind of stuff. Other people kind of just did their own thing, and it was good also. So I want to say, guys, everybody here, you should definitely be proud of yourself for the stuff that you put together. I thought all of them were clever, and they were good in their own ways. So thank you guys so much for putting out this content for everybody in the community today.
Yeah, and I know how hard this must have been for y'all, because, I mean, the time frame's pretty short. Some of the products that y'all came out with in less than a week was, I mean, it was inspiring, to be honest. I was very proud of all y'all. Y'all did great. I mean, this has been hard, but I hope it was worth it in the end for all y'all, because at the end of the day, you're here, and I hope you had fun. And, you know, we're about to get into the voting section, which, by the way, in case you don't know how it works, me, Emmy, Asmin are all going to get a vote. Chat is going to vote whether they liked y'all or not. You need 3 votes to continue minimum. If you get 2 votes of no, you are out. And we're going to get into that right now. And we're going to be starting with Mayor Wirtz.
All right. That sounds good.
Who wants Hello, to Mayor Wirtz.
Oh, wait. I get to go Hello. First, right?
We can go down. I'll go second if you want.
Okay. All right. But yeah, I want Asmund to have the easiest position possible because last time he had the hardest. So, Asmund, you can go whenever you want to go, okay?
Well, I liked it. I thought it was great. I thought it was a good video, and it was clever. Also, like, the switch at the end where I was expecting that it was just going to be a joke, but then it was, like, the steak thing. You changed the shirt. I thought that was funny. Everything about it fit together really well, and, like, for me, with a lot of videos, especially, like, skit-type videos, I'm always the mindset of, like, is this like, can I predict the end? And if I can't predict the end or I don't predict the end, I'm wrong about it. I really am impressed by that because I'd say 90% of the time, it's kind of easy to expect what's going to happen. So you were that 10% and that's why you passed.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I guess I'll go next. And first of all, chat, make sure to vote because every vote does matter. The poll is on your screen. Please, please, please vote. Your scoring was very good, Mayor. I'm going to be real. You're one of my favorite videos for today. I was thinking this guy might be too nice. This guy might be too positive, but you put your own spin on it. You played to your strengths. You roasted in a clever way. The effort you put into this was insane. And I respect hell out of you for how much effort you put in this because I know it was probably hard for the past week. It was probably hard, probably very busy, very stressful, but you killed it. And this was the easiest yes of my life. You did amazing, man.
Thank you. I have one question. Do you still hate me?
I never hated you, brother.
Good. Everyone, please clip that. I would like that as my ringtone. That would be great. Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course,
and winners win, of course. Yeah, obviously.
Winners win. Thank you, man.
All right. Should I go next? Okay.
Yeah, sure.
I liked that you pretty much took one point, like the bald thing, to focus on, and the video didn't feel mean, but it was still very entertaining. Like, it still felt like a roast, even though, like, there weren't really moments that were like, damn, oh, that hurts. It was still very entertaining and very good. I thought that all of the other actors that you had in it did a really good job, and they were a nice touch, but it also didn't feel like, you know, it still felt like your video, like you were still, like, the main part of the video. So I also put a yes. I thought it was very good.
Thank you very much.
Well, I already fucking voted, but we don't have a check mark next to me. So, like, we got 3 yeses. Who gives a fuck what chat thinks?
Yeah, fuck chat.
That's
What did chat say, though?
Wait, chat said yes with 92%.
Oh, my God. Wow.
That's pretty good number. That's pretty good number.
Good number. Yeah, exactly.
You are fighting, man. You've been here since episode 1. You just made it through episode 5. You should be proud of yourself, dog. Yeah. Keep it going, man.
I'm doing it. We're doing it.
Yep.
Good. Good, good, good. Anything else y'all have to say to Mayor Wirtz? Or Mayor Wirtz, do you have anything else you want to say?
I'm good on this end. If you guys got anything to say, please.
I'm chilling. I'm feeling good about it. I am, man. Congratulations. All right. And, awesome. We'll see you on the next round.
Yeah, next episode.
Good. Thank you.
I hope you're ready. See you later, man.
Peace.
I'm going to be real. Like, whenever he said 92% was pretty good, it triggered, like, some PTSD thing with me where, like, I would tell my dad I would get a 92% on a test and he'd ask me, what did I miss?
Oh, my God.
Like, I was just thinking about that. And, like, that's some fucking stepdad energy, you know? Like, and so it's like,
very fitting.
I'm sorry to hear that, man. But who do we got next? I think we're ready for Mr. Fimble to go up next. Let's just go ahead and let's not make him sweat too much. Let's get these people in here. Let's give them their scores and let's talk about how they did. Mr. Fimple, yo.
Yo, what's up?
How you feeling?
Hello. I'm feeling good. Yeah, I'm excited to see what happens.
Yeah, I don't think you should be feeling as good as you do feel because I'm gonna be real. Your video was shit.
Damn. I mean, thank you for giving to me straight, Tectone. I appreciate it.
Yeah, be real, don't like you, don't like your video. It really looked like you put zero effort into it, and honestly, it's kind of an embarrassment to what happened here. So it's going to be I'm just going to, your video is sick.
You already know how I feel. I was saying. So good, man. It was so good.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. Killed it. I mean, keep up this type of effort for every episode going forward. It's an easy yes from me. You did a great job, and you should be proud of yourself, man.
Thank you. Do you mind if I clip you saying my video is horrible and just run with that?
So you don't farm it, man. Farm it.
Post it on Twitter. I have already permission, like, but yeah, I definitely will. That'll be a TikTok.
There you go.
Emmy, you want to go?
All right. I felt like your video gave a pretty big insight into what kind of creator you are. Like, we could see your talent, your sense of humor, and I thought that was something that was pretty nice. You know, like, it was a video about someone else, but it also showed so much about yourself. It was beautiful, like, the shots, the lighting, it was all really good. The jokes were funny, so I put a yes. I liked it.
Thank you. I appreciate it, Imaru.
All right, so let's be real. It's not even a question. Obviously, this video was really good. You put it together really well. I think that, like, what really sold it to me is, again, like, what I look for whenever I see something like this is the intangibles, right? It's like the philosophy that goes into it. And whenever you did so many jokes that were just so, they were direct, but it was done in a show don't tell way. I was really impressed by that. It was very clever, and I think that it shows a certain level of confidence that you're willing to do that. And because of that, I'm going to absolutely give it a yes. It's not
Thank you.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. Yeah, I tried to make the jokes as visual as possible just to I just thought it was fun.
Yeah, I thought it was good. Well, what does chat have to say? How do they feel about it?
Let's find out.
Uh-oh. It's chat is a yes as well.
Chat with a yes with 90%?
Or yes. Four yes was wow.
Huge. Appreciate it.
That was really, really good. Congratulations. Yeah. Well, I guess you're moving on to the next round.
I guess so. Hey, as always, I appreciate you guys having me on. This is a super fun competition, so thank you.
Yeah. I mean, I hope you're prepared for tomorrow's episode, and be proud of yourself, dog. You killed it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Of course. Get some rest.
I will.
All right.
I will.
Oh, and also don't go anywhere. But afterwards. Like, don't leave the call.
I'm not gonna,
we need to
hang up right now. What, are they gonna go to bed right now? It's like 7 p.m.
Sleep right now.
I'm not going to bed at 7 p.m. I'm gonna wait at least like 9 or 10. Jesus.
All right, cool. Anyways, we'll see when we see it. Peace.
All right, thanks, man.
Damn, we've had two full yes contestants so far.
Well, we're gonna need to eliminate somebody, right?
Yep. Someone's gonna have to go home.
Yep. But I mean, obviously, I will just say it. I think those were the two strongest videos that were presented today, in my humble opinion, right? In my opinion.
I agree.
Yeah, they were very good, very well made. And the thing about this show is that somebody has to go home. Eventually, it's going to get down to one. So we will see when the no's start flying. We will see who goes home. I mean, maybe nobody does, but we'll have to see where chat votes and where y'all vote, because I have no idea where y'all's heads are at. Because I think for some of the contestants, me and you're on different pages, but we'll have to see.
I hope so. That means we get in an argument and there's more drama.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, next up we have Miss Skillshots.
Hello.
Hello. Yo, what up? You feeling okay?
Yeah.
Cool. Cool. Well, I'm gonna get right into it. Okay. Mm-hmm. I talked to you before this event and I said, you're a weeb. I'm stoked. You're one of my kind. You have the One Piece shirt. Very cool. And I watched your video and I have to admit it was not for me. The interactions, you know, they weren't really what I was hoping for. I do like the fact that you brought other contestants in who have been voted off. I think that was very smart. You're using what you had to your advantage. But I felt the pacing was a little bit weird. I found myself getting a little bit bored throughout the video. And I was hoping you would do a little bit more roasting of your target. But that didn't happen. But at the end of the day, it is what it is. And I'm glad that you tried your best. But for me, it is a no.
Thank you.
Yep.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and talk now. So, I thought it was great. I liked the video a lot. And the reason why, let's talk about why. Number one is I thought the collabs with a bunch of the other streamers, bringing them on, was really smart. And it's also something that a lot of streamers kind of shy away from, try to avoid doing, etc. I really liked it for that reason. Also, I think the fact that you did what you thought was the best inside of the situation that you were given. I think that also matters a lot. And then whenever you talk about like a YouTube video, everybody talks about, oh, well, let's go ahead and let's look at the, you know, let's look at the video, the contents of the video. Bro, like, you look at all these, there's plenty of garbage ass videos on YouTube with millions of views. And the reason for that is because they've got a good thumbnail or a good title. And I think really that does matter. And, you know, as somebody who is a master clickbaiter on YouTube, I've been doing this for a long time. I can absolutely respect another person who does that. So I think that the title, the video thumbnail were S tier. The idea that you had for the video was really good. Obviously, like, you're kind of, you're not an asshole, so you're probably not going to go and tell a bunch of jokes about a person you don't really know in that same way. It might make you uncomfortable, etc. So, like, I get the vibe. I totally understand it. And so I think that if I look at it from your perspective, you probably did probably what I would probably do, right, in your position. So I think that it's a yes for me.
Thank you. So in the same vein as Asmin, I kind of understood, because I feel like for me as well, when I, like, you know, try to, like, be jokingly mean to someone, sometimes it, like, doesn't get communicated very well because of my personality. I think that's kind of a similar thing for you, but I still thought that the video was well put together, and I really like that you brought back all the contestants that I said no to. Yeah, I just would like to see more of what you can do, even if, you know, being mean isn't your strongest suit. It's not for everyone, you know, but I thought it was a good video, and you clearly put work into it, so it was a yes for me as well.
Thank you.
And let's see what chat thought.
What the chat think?
This vote was 52%. Oh, I'm not sure which way it went. I'm not sure which way it went.
Oh, my God.
Okay, well, I'm going to give you the answer, and I don't know what it is, in 5, 4,
Jesus.
3, 2, 1. Peckies, what's the answer? The answer was no from chat. 52%.
Oh, damn. Missed skill
shots.
So
close.
Yeah, it was very close. You know, you've got to remember that a lot of the people in this chat, these are people whose minds are warped by the cruelties of the internet. They grew up watching YouTube videos that I don't even want to say the name of in a sponsored stream. And you can't expect them to appreciate how nice you are. And it's okay.
Of course.
Thank you very much for being part of the show.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Great.
And the other thing is, even though you may not have won the event, I mean, you still won over a lot of people. I think your streams are going to go great. I think you're going to do amazing. And I still hope that you are proud of what you did.
I am. Thank you. Yeah,
of course. And thank you for being on here.
Thank you, Miss Skillshots.
Right. Well, don't go anywhere. We'll talk to you soon, and we'll see you later.
Peace.
Peace.
52%, huh?
It was close.
Oh, my God. That was really close. Holy shit.
Very, very, very close.
Damn, y'all were right on the edge. Yeah, it's like, I can see how people would look at that video and, like, not really know how to react to it, because it's like, it's so hard to put yourself in the position of another person and then know how to do it right. Because, again, like, roasting people, etc., people always kind of go over the line sometimes, and it's hard to know where that line is. So I can appreciate and respect a person who's, like, not necessarily, trying to go down that. I think it was fun.
Right. Also, this contest is hard. Like, these streamers are tested on, like, 8 different specialties. Most big streamers only have 2 to 3 specialties, and these people are having to go out of their comfort zone. So, I mean, respect for trying. They all did a really good job.
Let's go ahead. Let's keep it even more real than that. Most streamers play one fucking video game, and they play one character in one fucking video game.
Yep. All right, well, I was trying to be generous, but whatever.
Yep.
Yeah, let's be honest.
The other thing is, though, I mean, she should be very proud of herself. At the end of the day, I mean, she still won a round. Very good. She tried her best. I think she put her best foot forward, and she's going to be fine, because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who wins. Well, obviously, it does matter who wins, but even being on the show is great, and she has a promising future ahead of her. I'm sure of that.
Oh, but, absolutely. Yeah.
Next up, we have the next one we're talking to Sun Cracker. Yo.
Yo, what up?
Yo, what's up, guys?
How you doing? All right, who wants to go first? You want me to go first?
No, I'll go first. Unless you want to go first, but I volunteer to go first every time.
Shut up, go first.
Okay, cool. First of all, Sun Cracker, how you feeling?
I'm a little nervous, I'm gonna be honest. YouTube and scripted content is objectively one of my weaker points as a creator, so already a little nervous. Then I was, you know, coming a little sick this week, so had to find the time for it, but I think I did what I could with what I had.
Cool. So I'll go ahead and get started. So first of all, I really liked how hard you went in. I respect the hell out of that. I think you had a lot of funny jokes. You did the bald. You were on me, and I think that was good. And you really, really, you know, showed that you had the wit to make some funny jokes and roast me, and it was good. The unfortunate reality is that this is a competition versus other creators, and I do have to compare your video to some of the other contestants. And by comparison, I mean it was pretty stiff competition. It really was. Yeah. I think you said it yourself. It was a Twitch streamer's YouTube video, but at the end of the day, we got to get down to one person. And compared to some of the other contestants, I feel like you came up just a little bit short. It is going to be a no from me, but I do think that you know, you'll keep going strong.
All right, thank you.
Yep. Well, Osmond's camera's gone now too. It actually is spreading. He said my streaming PC had a critical error, blue screen.
Yeah, that was my fault.
Oh, Techie, why?
Yeah, my bad, guys. Well, you want to do your take, and we can get it going. I mean, while he's repairing his PC.
Oh, hold on, I just ripped out my earbud.
Sure.
Okay. So, a lot of the jokes I thought were very funny, and it was a longer video. It was 7 minutes, and I understand, like, it's hard to have a, you know, super captivating, funny video all throughout, but a lot of the jokes to me felt just mean and not funny, which I know it's a roast, but it's like, it's crazy when even I'm like, damn, like, I feel kind of bad for Tektone, you know what I'm saying? But I
thought
that...
Don't feel bad for me at all.
Okay, I'll stop that. I did like the style where you did, like, you know, it was your stream, it was clips of your stream. It did feel like a streamer's YouTube channel. That was nice, but the video just didn't really hit for me, so I also put a no. I'm sorry.
That's fine. I respect that.
Cool.
Yeah, it's a tough balance between hitting Tektone's level and the average person's level, and I tried to find a medium there, and I missed the mark.
I mean, to be honest, I'll be real, dog. I still think as a YouTube video, like, it was still very strong. Like, I do think you have good wit. I really do.
Everyone killed it this episode.
Let me ask you a question. Would you consider yourself more of a YouTuber or like a Twitch streamer?
Oh, Twitch streamer, 100%.
100%. That came through in the video. And, you know, there's a lot of things, and I want you to take this and know this. There are a lot of YouTubers where, like, the edits and, like, the film, you know, it makes them seem very interesting, and then you get to their stream, and it's pretty boring, right? I can tell that from that video, your wit is going to be there on stream. I can tell that live entertainment is a lot better, your strong suit. So I hope this doesn't discourage you, and I hope you keep streaming, because I think you have a lot of promise on me, for real.
Oh, for sure, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Well, since Asma's not here, I think we can go ahead and see what chat said. And chat also did vote a no. Yo, Asma, are you back? Can you hear us?
I can hear y'all. Give me one sec. I'm going to get my camera back on. Fucking streaming PC went and did, like, you know that thing where it puts a sad face?
Yeah,
that's about it. Okay, all right. Is it my turn now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Apologies, guys. Really, really sorry about this. The PC is out to get me. Actually, that's actually not true, guys. I'm going to just go ahead and let you know. I actually just turned it off. That way, I would make Emeru have to be the person to give you the no.
Classic.
Yeah, sorry about that. But, you know, you got to do it. Now, listen, Suncracker, you ever been in a class where, like, let's say, for example, you've got a decent presentation, but you're sandwiched between, like, let's say, the valedictorian and, like, the teacher's kid?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's about the way I'm feeling about today.
Yep.
I think that today you did a good job. It was a good video. And if you're a streamer making YouTube videos, I think that you're staying the course. You're doing what you need to do. It's fine. But in terms of quality, the other videos were just simply better. There was more quality and more effort put into them. So I'm going to give it a no. But, I mean, as I said, the videos are good. It's just that comparatively, it's a no.
Right.
So that's where we're at.
Cool. Well, I mean, you heard from us, Son Cracker. I hope this doesn't discourage you at all. I hope you keep going and make sure to stay in the call. But we'll talk to you again very soon, okay?
All right. Thanks again, guys.
Yep. Peace, homie.
Give me one sec. I should be almost done.
Yeah, take your time. This is going.
Man, what are y'all getting sad about? Like, y'all quit fucking getting sad about this shit.
I'm not sad about it at all. Nobody here's sad. Hey, man.
Bro, it's just, you
do I
sure?
look sad? I get that a lot.
I'm good.
Okay. You know? All right.
I'm not sad.
I think we're doing what needs to be done. And it's a little bit of a bloodbath.
Good. Delicious.
So, I mean, you know, we're stunned. I thought before coming into this show, I thought we'd maybe get one up, but we already got two off and there's still two left to be voted. I mean, this might be the most people eliminated from an episode, depending on what happens over the next couple of votes.
We're going to have to find out. We're going to have to see.
Yes, let's see right now. Let's get Zion in the call.
All right.
Get ready. I'm in. Get ready.
Yo. What up, Jimmy? Zion, how you feeling, buddy?
I'm doing good. I feel pretty good. I don't want to seem cocky, but I'm not cocky. I'm just ready. I'm ready for the Corey.
Cool. Well, then why don't I just go ahead and start then? So here's the thing. When I saw the video, and once again, everything that you said, I'm taking at face value. I am trusting you that you did not lie like I would. When I watched the video, you had a lot of people like doing the work for you. And at first I thought, okay, that is a streamer strat, 100%. Because it was a funny video. I was like, wow, these guys are pretty funny. But then at the end, you said that you scripted everything. And I respect that, okay? Because then you elevate your friends that you brought in the video by delivering them good lines, good content. And that's admirable. So I will let you know, I was at a no after I watched the video. But once you told me you scripted it, and I'm trusting you, I did get to a yes. Sweet. I think that was a good collaboration. I think you put your best foot forward. And there was some good content there, man. There was some good content.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Thank you.
You know what you know what your video reminded me of? It reminded me of Aiden Ross's announcement video moving over to Kick.
It was that like, bad?
No, it was good. I mean, like, bro, like that. I mean, yo, like, they put a lot of money into that, so it was pretty good. It was actually good. Like, I actually liked the video, and it was funny. Like, especially like you had some really really good points. Like, as I said, that dude that was just sitting up there talking shit. No way. I actually, like, I'm going to be real. The one thing that I think would have made it even funnier is if that dude that was asleep never woke up.
Yeah.
Just straight up. Yeah. Like, it was just asleep the whole time.
We were going with that bit, but then when we decided post-editing, we're like, wait, he's only excited for Iran. Yeah.
No, I think that's clever. That's definitely the next best thing. And maybe that's better. It's like, how can you go back in time and change something else? So long and short of it, I talk about all the positives about the video, but the reality is, I mean, you see him talking about this many positives. It's obviously a yes. It was a good video.
Sweet. Thank you. Good job, man. Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you very much.
All right. So the beginning of the video, like the first 30 seconds or so, I wasn't so sure about it. But as I got into the video, it was super funny. I thought that all the people that you brought on were really funny. I just thought it was a great video, good jokes. It felt like it was a produced skit. It was nice. So in the same vein as Tektone, I thought it was nice that, you know, you elevated your friends, your actors. But I really wished it felt like you were like the star of the video, because it's supposed to be your video. You know what I mean? Like, even though you scripted it. It felt like it wasn't like coming from you, if that makes sense. So I put a no, unfortunately.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Oh boy. That is not good. Okay. Got you. Thank you, Amy.
Sorry.
Chat.
Chat, what y'all think?
What y'all gonna say? What's it gonna be? Let's go. Let's get those percentages out,
Help
gentlemen.
Help me out, y'all. Help me out. Come on, boys.
Let's see.
Come on.
And the chat said, pause champ. 3, 2, 1.
Let's go!
That's right.
Let's go. Thank you so much.
I like seeing that passion, man. I'm glad that you're excited to be here, dog. I hope you get on the next episode, dog.
Yes, thank you very much. Yes, this is a dream come true. It's a blessing. Every episode, I'm going to go full out. So thank you very much. And thank you for your feedback.
Absolutely, man. Hell yeah. Thank you.
Sweet. Thank you.
Damn, that was fucked up for you to give him a no. Wow, like that's oh my god.
I literally have one criticism, but I felt like it just needed to be said. But it was still a really good video. I still enjoyed it.
I'm glad you said it because the odds are that somebody else out there felt the same way that you did. It might not be the mainstream opinion. It doesn't matter. I mean, you felt the way you did. You can't help that.
Yeah, I'm glad that he made it through. But, I mean, I try to not vote yes on literally everyone, even though I want to. Uh-huh. So that criticism really stuck out to me, so I just wanted to say it.
Yeah.
No, I know. I'm goofing around, guys, before y'all actually get mad.
Yeah. Well, we have one more contestant left to go. And it's Mr. Evan Gao. So why don't we get him in here? Chat, be ready to cast your vote. Emmy Asman, let's do what needs to be done. Yo, what up, Evan?
Nice to be back here.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm excited. I've really enjoyed like hearing your guys' insights on everyone's videos, and I'm excited to see what you say for me.
Okay. Well, then why don't I just go ahead and get started and not waste anybody's time here. So watching your video was... It produced a very, very mixed feeling in my head. I liked how self-aware you are. I think there's a lot of great streamers that use that quality of self-awareness in order to understand their own humor, be aware of what's cringe, and use that to your advantage, right? Like, doing something cringe or unintentionally is weird, but doing it intentionally is hilarious, right? And I feel like you're a very aware streamer. The pacing of your video, I instantly understood the references to Andy Samberg and his self-roast 100%, as well as I loved your transitions with the shit. Felt you were assigned to roast Extra Emily, and it felt like an Extra Emily video. I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but it did feel like a Extra Emily video, like something that even she would make, right? Just like what's the word? The endearing level of cringe. Mm-hmm. Now, I will say, some of the montage you did, as I said before, were a little bit weird. And I will have to let you know, before I really thought about it, I was on the fence of saying no for you. Because I was comparing it to everybody else's. But I do think that the video that you did brought something that almost every other video didn't. Which is just like the unapologetic way that you were yourself for this video, the way that you presented yourself, the intentionally cringe shit. I was weird about it at first. The more I think about it, the more I like it. And something in my heart is telling me to give you a yes. So I am changing my no to a yes.
All right. Thank you.
Yep.
Asman, you want me to go next?
I don't give a fuck. I'll go next. How about that?
Oh, sure.
How about that? Yeah, I'll go next. All right. So it's what kind of the way I look at it, right? Is like whenever you go and you do a video where it's like one of those like anti-joke, you flip the script, etc. I felt like the video, again, like a lot of the other ones, there was a lot more effort and time put into them. Yours, not really as much. And it's like maybe it was in a way, but it just didn't really come off that way to me. Also, it was confusing to me, like what you were trying to do. Like about halfway through the video, I was like, wait, what the fuck is going on? Like, I felt like I was in one of those like weird, crazy, like Christopher Nolan, like, are we talking like this is Inception, Interstellar, Memento, like Shutter Island shit, or like, am I the crazy one watching a video or what? It was confusing to me. And so overall, I would say the video is a no, but I think it's something that you can work on, and I like the idea of it.
Okay.
Yeah, it's enough.
I'll definitely work on like the structure.
Yeah, it was confusing.
Okay, well, I hadn't fully decided what I wanted to say yet, but something that Asman said made me decide my opinion. So Asman said that he felt like the video didn't have as much effort as the others, right? Asman, just because the quality of the camera does not look as good does not mean it has less effort. Like, I've done video editing too, so I know how much time you put into all those edits. Like, you probably had like 10 fucking layers in Adobe Premiere.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the video. Yeah, I enjoyed the video. I also appreciated that. Well, I don't know if I appreciated, but I thought it was nice that you roasted me in the beginning, so I actually did get roasted today. And yeah, I thought it was a good video. I enjoyed the Zoomer humor. I thought it was good. It's a yes for me.
All right, thank you.
Oh, it's going to be down to chat.
We got one more vote, and that's chat's vote. So,
rage.
55% one way, and we don't know which way that is. So I'm listening to production right now. Hold on, I'm getting a call.
Okay.
Yeah.
55%? Okay. And which way are we thinking? Oh. Oh. Okay.
Monka?
I'll tell him. Wait! They called back. You're serious? Okay, I'll tell him. We're showing the result. In 5, 4, oh, shit. 3, 2, 1. There it is, man!
Damn,
you made
you
it through!
Oh,
you
right.
made
Congrats,
it through!
Devin.
All right.
There you
Thank
go.
You, chat.
55% yes. That was a close one, man.
Yeah, that got my heart pounding.
Yep.
I was a little bit unsure, too, to be honest. I didn't know what to think.
Yeah, so did I, because production told me it said no. And then I was like, oh, God. And then they said, no, it's actually a yes.
Yeah.
So I hope you don't think that I was fucking with you. That was, that
I,
was
thought, I thought you were
mother.
Doing a bit.
That was,
I was
no,
so confused.
They were talking to me in my ear, but simple. Well, that was a close one there, Evan. So I hope that you're ready for next episode and be ready to kill it for that episode, okay? Don't make the next one a close one. I want you to go in there and I want you to annihilate.
I definitely will.
Okay. Well, stick around, but we'll see you in a little bit.
All right.
Congrats again. Well, there it is. Two were outed this episode?
Yep, two.
I was getting the vibe that we might have. I mean, it was close there. It was close.
It was very close.
Yeah, we almost had four out of that episode, but a couple people got through by the skin of their teeth, and
well,
hopefully
chat.
That's a wake-up call for some of our contestants.
Yeah, the chat decided.
Yep.
Yeah. I mean, regardless, I feel like the feedback was great for all contestants all aboard, but I mean, why don't we pull the contestants back in and see how they're feeling? Welcome back,
Question
everyone. Welcome back.
Hello.
I mean, yeah. Let's see here. So we have Mayor Wirt, Stan, Mr. Fimplestan, Miss Skillshots, unfortunately leaving with Suncracker. Zion and Evan are staying as well. So we lost two promising contestants today, but I think you guys should be proud of yourselves. You all tried your best. And regardless of whether you're staying or whether you're going home, just know that, you know, we were glad that you were here, and I hope that you enjoyed the experience.
Yeah, it was a blast. Super hard challenge, but I think it was really fun.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like Elevate is all about getting, you know, streamers out of their comfort zones, doing things that they're going to eventually need to do. I mean, it's hard, right? Because I'll be real. I mean, shit, if I was on this show, I wouldn't even make it past a round or two. This is difficult, bro. This is difficult. Yep. So, I mean, y'all should be very proud of yourselves. This is a tough round. Also, Miss Skillshot, you're muted.
Yeah. Sorry.
We are starting the poll, chat, for who y'all want to go see after this. We will be raiding into them. And, feel free to vote for which streamer you want to go see. Emmy, Asmund, any final closing thoughts?
I think you guys did great. Honestly, like, these videos were really impressive. And I want to say again, like, even the ones I voted no on, I still like and appreciate them. And I'm actually really impressed to see the kind of content people came up with today. It was clever, and a lot of it was unexpected in a good way. So thank you, guys.
It was very hard to put any no's. You guys all did good. I really enjoyed all the videos. They were all really entertaining. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I want to remind chat real quick that we do have a Starforge PC giveaway happening right now. And I want to remind you guys that it's not the same giveaway as the one last week. This is a brand new Starforge giveaway. So if you didn't enter last time, it's okay. This is, you know, a unique thing. So get in there. Enter the giveaway. You know, 4090 GeForce RTX Intel Core i9-13900K. Follow every creator here, you know, follow your favorites, go talk in their chat, regardless of what we all voted here. It doesn't matter. If you like someone from today's stream, go follow them, support them. All the creators here have been absolutely amazing. And I mean, you like who you like, go support the channel of the people that you vibed with.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And Sweet. The poll results are in. And the person and the who chat wants to go see is actually, I believe, the birthday girl, Miss Skillshots.
So we will be raiding into missed skill shots after this. And, you know, if that doesn't speak volumes, I don't know what does. I mean, happy birthday. That's amazing.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you.
Of course. Of course. Of course. But, yeah, I want to thank all y'all for coming, and I want to thank Progressive and Allied Esports for sponsoring today's episode of OTK Elevated. We will be seeing y'all tomorrow, I believe, on Soda Poppin's channel. I don't know if we have a graphic for what the schedule's looking like for OTK Elevated. I'd love to pull that up right now to remind everybody of what's going on for the future of OTK Elevated. And we do. Amazing. We have Soda Poppin tomorrow. We have Seer on May 24th. S-Van TV on May 25th, TBA on May 31st and June 1st. Who could that be? I don't know. I guess we'll find out who that is for the final two episodes. Could be anybody. Suncracker, before we get you off the show, do you have any final words you want to say for your experience?
I would say, I said it last week, it was corny, but I'll say it again. Thanks to OTK for doing this. Nobody is putting small streamers on like this. But you guys, you've, like, Navius, Oofy, Miss Skillshots, Fimple, everybody has been killing it with or without the show, being kicked off, how many ever episodes they've gotten. It's been crazy, the amount of support we've all gotten through this.
Yeah, it's insane. Well, I appreciate the kind words, man. Miss Skillshots, you want to say anything?
Thank you so much for the raid and the opportunity to be here. It was really fun, and I got to meet Emmy. And that was a dream come true. Thank you.
Oh, what the heck?
That's awesome. Well, I hope you have a very happy birthday. And thank you again for coming
Thank
out.
You.
Of course. Yeah. Well, I guess this is where we say our goodbyes. Bye.
All right, guys. Yo, thanks a lot for coming on the show. I appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
Wow, okay. Bye, yeah, bye.
Yeah. Leave. The show's over, guys. Leave.
See y'all later.
That was fun. That was good.
Y'all feel good about the show? How y'all feeling? Feeling good?
I feel great. I'm glad that Miss Skillshots is getting the raid. I think that's very cool. Because at that's the end nice. Of the day, I mean, she won over the hearts of a lot of people, which I think is great. I mean, regardless of who wins, be a judge vote or by chat vote, I think the important thing is that a lot of these streamers have the opportunity to pick up new viewers that really vibe with them and find out what they're about. Because, you know, I mean, let's be real. In a million people, if 90% of them don't like you but 10% do, that's still 10% new people that you get to talk to and interact with along the way, which I think is a great opportunity.
That's a lot. Like 10% of a million is like 100,000. That's a lot of people.
That is a lot of people.
Yeah. That's crazy. That's
what,
a lot.
What are you? Is that chicken and broccoli?
Yeah, chicken, Brussels sprouts, and rice.
What the fuck?
Well, I've been eating disgusting ass shit all day.
Where's the steak?
Oh, I had that.
Good?
Oh, what? Well, yeah, I mean, but the Brussels sprouts are pretty rough, I'm not going to lie. I had steak, sweet potatoes.
You said
chicken's good?
Yeah.
Chicken's all right, but so is steak is more all right.
Oh, steak's the best, but sometimes,
steak
you know.
Steak is so good. You know what else? I think turkey's better than chicken. That's right.
Mm.
No,
you know what's better
That's
than both of that
wrong.
Shit?
That's just wrong.
Progressive and Allied Esports are better than both. The sponsors of today's stream of OTK Element. We love you guys so much. Hearts and easy claps in the chat for Progressive and Allied Esports. Oh, by the way, dude, thank you guys for being a host for this show. I mean, I really appreciate y'all's time. And I hope you enjoyed it. I had fun.
I had fun, too. It was good. I enjoy doing this. I get to sit here and just judge people. Yeah, it's great.
Yeah,
I like it.
We get to be a viewer.
Yeah, I do get to be a viewer, exactly.
I don't know what you guys are doing with us. I'm going to pull a Jingyu on. What are y'all doing?
I am going to probably lay on my futon for 30 minutes and read posts about myself. And then after that, I'll probably get out of bed and then fuck around for 20 more minutes and then go live. And probably... I figure, like, for the new character, I figure I might as well just get... I might as well just get him 7 times today. Just
yeah, well,
okay. I was just going to stare at this feeling.
Oh. Okay, cool.
That sounds exciting. Wow.
Yeah.
Well, I'm probably going to raid and then go live again later and then be trying to pull for Jingyuan and it not work out and then be depressed and then think about wailing and then
ask myself, why am I cucking myself in a gacha game, and then get really depressed, and then call the car for support, but then it'll probably call me a pussy, and we'll see where it goes from there. It's going to be a rough day.
You can always just watch me.
Yep. Well, Emmy, Asm, once again, thanks for being here. I really hope you all enjoyed the time chat. Thank you for being here as well. Thank you for supporting smaller streamers. This is what all this is about. It's very hard to get discovered sometimes on Twitch. So, big shout outs to OTK for putting on an event like this that helps so many people get the spotlight they so deserve. We have some amazing contestants that we had on this week. We're going to have even better contestants next week. Everybody's going to have to step up their game because it's getting thin. People are getting called off every single day. But we hope that y'all enjoy the show. Whether you agreed with us, whether you disagreed with us, doesn't matter. Just go support the streamers that you found today that you really vibed with. Appreciate all y'all guys being here. Once again, big shout out to OTK, Allied Esports, Progressive, all y'all. Emmy, Asmin, thank you all so much. But that is the end of the stream, guys.
All right, boys. Thanks a lot. I'll see y'all later. Peace.
Thanks, Techie.
Peace, y'all. Of course.
See you guys.